Very good morning to everyone. So we are going to start our meeting. It's already 11:10. So first of all, on behalf of Dispur Law College and Assam College Librarians Association, I'd like to welcome you all in this platform of webinar on awareness program on online e-resources. And this is in fact a great moment for us that we are connected with a law college, and it's a great honor for us that we are not only confined to the general colleges of Assam, but also we have extended to the law colleges, and it's a great honor for us. And we have lots of participants, we can say lots of academicians from different corners of Northeast, from Shillong, from Jorhat, Dibrugarh, and rest of the corners of Assam. So I'm Dr. Virendra Pal. I am the coordinator of ICT Cell, Assam College Librarians Association, and also the librarian of Koliyabar College. And this is the great moment. So without wasting much time, I would like to invite Honorable Principal of Dispur Law College, Dr. Gargi Dattopal Madam, to give her welcome address. Madam, please.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, everybody. Respected keynote speaker, Dr. Prashanta Pikedekar, our learned resource persons, and our esteemed participants. I'm Dr. Gargi Dattopal, Principal, Dispur Law College. We are all aware that coronavirus pandemic has upended our lives. It has caught us in a maelstrom. Thus, the Indian scenario of education has turned from face-to-face interaction in classrooms to e-educations supported by e-resources. It is now an opportunity to explore the immense knowledge trapped through e-education. Today's awareness program is on the use of online e-resource. It is a fillip to explore the world of digital learning. Ladies and gentlemen, let me take this opportunity to extend my warm welcome to Dr. Prashanta Kumar Dekar, General Secretary, Assam College Librarian Association. He's presently working as librarian, KC Das Commerce College, Guwahati. A very welcome to you, sir. I heartily welcome resource person of today's webinar, Dr. Konkana Boshter, Assistant Librarian, National Law University and Judicial Academy. We are happy to have you amongst us, madam. I extend my genial welcome to resource person, Dr. Nikhil Hazareka, member, ICT Cell of Assam College Librarian Association. He is presently holding the post of librarian, IC, in Madhav Dev University. I extend my most courteous welcome to Dr. Virendra Pal, coordinator, ICT Cell, Assam College Librarian Association, and the resource person of today's webinar. He is holding the post of librarian, Koliyabar College. I extend my friendly welcome to all the principals present here in this platform. My bright-heartedly welcome to all the faculty members of the library, and research scholars who are amongst us today in this webinar. Welcome all to this webinar. It is a gateway to the inner beauty of the vast resources trapped in this digital world. It's a call upon us to explore the same. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. It's a really great honor for us to hear you in this platform. Thank you. So next, I'd like to invite Honorable General Secretary of Assam College Librarians Association, Dr. Prashanta Kumar Dekar sir. Dekar sir is really much, very much busy person, but although he's very much busy, but always he's thinking about us, and he's giving guidance to Assam College Librarians Association. And because of his guidance, we could organize this kind of program. And really, sir, it's a great honor. Sir, kindly give your speech, sir, please. Yes.
Honorable Principal Madam, Dispur Law College, Dr. Gargi Dattopal, Resource Person of today's program, Dr. Konkana Boshter, National Law University and Judicial Academy, Assam, Dr. Nikhil Hazarika, Librarian, Madhav Dev University of Member of ICT Cell, SCNA, Dr. Virendra Pal, Convener ICT Cell, SNA, Librarian Collaborator College, respected faculties of this college, respected participants of this webinar. I, on behalf of SNA, I welcome all of you to this wonderful program. As our principal madam informed that and noted that due to the pandemic situation, the present society has great loss in entire country, entire area. All the educational institutions are closed last 2.5 months across the country. Our students' community badly affected. According to latest report of UNESCO, more than 1.5 billion students and youth across the planet are affected by the schools and university closure due to the COVID-19 outbreak. As after imposing of lockdown in the country, all higher education and as well as our legal education institutions are closed. MHRD, UGC, as well as Bar Council of India has taken lots of initiative to minimize present loss of our students' lives. Already the Bar Council of India, BCI, has directed to the all legal education institutions taking them to all online classes to cover the syllabus as far as practical as with the COVID-19 situation. It is good that national law universities and several other centers of legal education has already commenced online classes. Already 90% of law universities like IIT Law School of Noida, Army Institution of Law, Mohali, Law School of
We lost connection with Deka sir. Deka sir. Deka sir, can you hear me? Okay, no problem. Okay, so thank you, Deka sir. When you will connect, we will definitely will resume. Next, I'd like to, first of all, we have with us Professor Sanjay Kumar Singh sir also. He was with us and he is also the guest of honor for this today's program. Professor Sanjay Kumar Singh sir is the head of the Department of Library and Information Science, Guwahati University. And among us we have the resource person, Dr. Kantona Vishwa Madam, Assistant Librarian, National Judicial Academy, National Law University and Judicial Academy, And we have among with us Dr. Nikhil Hazarika, the Librarian in Charge of Madhav Dev University. So this both of the resource persons have their own domain in the expertise in the different fields. So I welcome them in this platform. And I just invite first Dr. Kankana Vishwa Madam to give her presentation. Madam, please.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
So thank you, Dr. Virendra Pal, for giving me this opportunity to share my experience. At the very outset, I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks and congratulations to both the esteemed organization as well as association, Dispur Law College, as well as Assam College Library Association for choosing this very imperative topic, considering the today's scenario. This COVID-19 pandemic situation, of course, this is very important and imperative for all the entire academic fraternity worldwide to ponder upon and rely upon the online electronic resources as well as online teaching and learning. So I would like to add, cover the So basically we can see that entire web is flooded with the information, and for us it is very difficult to rely upon what information is authentic and what information is not authentic or not useful for us. So I have basically want to cover certain electronic resources, basically in the field of law and allied subjects, and would like to share my presentation here.
Madam, please share your screen.
Can you see my screen?
No, madam. Just go to this option, share a screen.
No. I'm just trying to share my screen, but.
Yeah. Yes. Now it is shared.
Yeah.
Yes. Fine, madam. We can see now.
Can you share? Can you see?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. So, I just want to cover the online legal electronic resources, which are the licensed and commercial e-resources, then again open access resources. Would like to give a gist on institutional repository. Those are also very important resources. Then also copyright issues related to online resources, and also would like to give a glimpse over the electronic services that National Law University and Judicial Academy Library is offering to its user. So in this slide, I have given the list of mostly used licensed and commercial e-resources. I have done the survey among the 23 university, National Law University libraries, and basically they have been using these resources in their library. We all know that licensed and commercial e-resources are the paid resources. We'll have to sign an agreement with the particular agency and vendors, and for a particular period, and then we can get subscription of the publishing contents and particular content. So there are a copyright is involved by using these online resources. You can see AR Online is a product which contains all the publishing of the publications of online All India Report. Then Corporate Law Advisor is one of the resources which contains the corporate law contents, related contents. Then Telnet contains bibliographic and full text contents of social sciences. InOnline is an international database which contains US, UN resources, reports, treaties, etc. Then JSTOR, you can see JSTOR is a social science database, contains the current as well as archival issue of social science contents, and also pure arbitration contains the international arbitration search. Nexus India Advanced contains the commentary or commentary lots of books as well. Then also Manipatra is a very widely used resources in all over nation. Then SCC Online is one of the best resources that our user used to say. SCC Online contains the Supreme Court cases. Taxman Taxation Database also contains direct, indirect tax related contents. UN Depository is a repository of UN contents. Then Westlaw is the international content again. and also World Trade Law contains the trade contents, trade international trade contents. And India State also is a database which contains the statistics of various specific domains like economics, also crime in children and banking sector, etc. So I will go, actually I cannot go deep to all the electronic resources, but I will show a glimpse of two or three databases that our university has been subscribing. And while we also sometimes subscribe the electronic books, while subscribing those electronic books and other electronic resources, we should read the terms and conditions very well, and also we'll have to be clear whether this is a perpetual access or is a particular for a particular time being. So we should be very clear about those issues while subscribing these electronic resources in our library or in your organization. So while using these electronic resources, we should keep in a consideration there are certain things you are which is not permitted while using these electronic contents. Systematic and bulk downloading is not permitted. Then also using electronic resources for commercial purpose is not permitted. We cannot remove or modify any licensed materials, and we cannot make online content available to unauthorized users. Suppose I have been, our university has been using the databases, we cannot give the access to the other member of other university or colleges. So posting content of a licensed article to an open site is also not permissible. Circulating full text content online and offline is also not permissible. So viewing, downloading, copying, printing and saving a copy of search results is permissible. Then you can use a resource for educational, research, teaching and personal study. Mailing an article to another authorized user, you can authorized user who is mail the article to a user of our National Law University Library, because I have been subscribing to particular database. And we can post a URL which is publisher's version of the article on a website. So these are the issues we should keep in our mind while using the subscribed electronic resources of a particular organization and institution. So you being a law fraternity, you are basically award Information Technology Act 2000. If anything found, any violation of copyright is to happen, then the person will be liable under this Information Technology Act 2000. So depending upon the damage, the compensation may go up to 1 crore rupees to the person who affected. Now coming to the online free e-resources by HRD Ministry. There are lots of electronic resources which are openly accessible. But you can also find out lots of electronic resources which is a category of very reputed publishers. Suppose Oxford, Cambridge, then Elbel Online, Zeal, these are the reputed publishers. And you will find always the open access category contents of the particular and reputed publishers also you can find out. And you can collect likewise these three resources from reputed publishers. So here I have quoted, here I have noted certain initiative taken by the HRD Ministry, UGC, and Inclinet, as well as Consortium for Educational Communications, which are very much important and valuable for teachers, students, and researchers of the university and colleges for learning. So I think one of our resource person, Virendra, will cover the most of the parts of the these contents, but I will just want to read out what are the contents, what are the initiatives taken by the government for online and teaching and learning. One is Swayam online courses, which contains teaching and learning resources. Then UGPG MOOC, which is UG and PG of Swayam courses are included. EPG Pachala is a high quality curriculum based in content or which contains postgraduate disciplines of social science, arts, finance, and humanities, etc. Then CAC courseware in UG subject contains unlimited educational curriculum that's based lectures, absolutely free. Then one is Swayamprabha. It's a Swayamprabha also contains educational curriculum based teaching learning materials. Then CAC YouTube matter, CAC UGC YouTube channels, and then national digital library. Excuse me. Okay. Yes, National Digital Library, which is a very good initiative. Was a very good initiative of and IIT Kharagpur, because these contents are also accessible by differently able learners, because these section of the society are nowadays facing a lot of problems due to this online learning and teaching environment, and National Digital Library contents can be accessible to the differently able learners as well. And then coming to the Shodhganga. Shodhganga is, we all basically know that it's a repository of thesis, electronic thesis and dissertation submitted by the universities all over the India. So it's a very important institutional repository site of internet, which contains the we can carry on our research work by going through the Shodhganga site. Coming to the next slide, there are the other open access materials. You can see Ministry of External, because nowadays all the government organizations are giving their contents openly accessible in their websites. So you can see Ministry of External Affairs, DDS, INCODIS, LIN, Portal of Government of India, PRS Legislative Research, Law Commission of India reports, National Women Commission reports, then National Human Rights. National. National Human Rights Commission reports, India Labor Archives, Open Access Journal Search Engine, and Directory of Open Access Search, Director of Open Access Journal, Indian Kanun, Vakil Number 1, Advocate Force, Human Rights Law Network, Directory of Open Access Books, Open Library in Indian Law Institute. These are some of the open access materials. There are many more open access materials available over the web. But these are a little bit qualitative, and you can also rely on the Open Access Journal Search Engine, Directory of Open Access Journals, which contains very qualitative open access journals. So coming to the institutional repository. Institutional repository is also, we can rely upon the institutional repository of particular institution, because the institutional repository, you can also include your classroom teaching material. Suppose you take class using Google Classroom, then you can upload your lectures in the classroom, and accordingly you can also upload it in your institutional repository. Your institutional repository may contain the assignments, lectures, audio visual, multimedia presentation, research materials, including research products such as research paper, and also the book chapters, conference. So it can be anything. And National Digital Library is one of the examples of this institutional repository. So I would like to request all the faculty members to come up with their presentation, with their lectures, and submit in the repository of your institution, because nowadays institutional repository becomes mandatory for all the academic institutes, and that is why NDL has started started taking the contents from various colleges because to have their your own server in a college is a very costly affair, and that is why National Digital Library has given the server a free of cost server for to upload their contents in the National Digital Library platform. So because our National University is also having one digital repository signed MOU with NDL, and we also upload our publications, faculty publications, as well as institute's publication in our repository. It is very important because it also creates it's also increase your citation impact if you upload your suppose research paper also, your publication also, you can submit into the repository. But you will be very much clear about the copyright issues about on your publications, because whenever you publish, you should be very aware about the right, whether you have given the right to the publisher or you have kept the right with you. Also, if you don't know about the copyright aspect, you can still upload it in your institutional repository. If it infringes the copyright, then automatically Digital Millennium Copyright Act, under this act, under the provision of this act, it will be request to remove the particular content from the institutional repository. So we should be aware about the uploading of the scholarly content in our institutional repository. So this is a theoretical aspects of our presentation. So we can also visit our university library website. I will go to the website directly. Yes, here you can see this is our website, and in the collection option e-resource tab, you will find all these e-resources. What are the subscribed databases we have been subscribing for our university, as well as the information on open access resources by MHRD and also other open access resources. So I would like to tell the university, the librarian of the academic institutes, and all the faculty members also, you can also have your own set of open access resources in your website. Nowadays you can open a website free of cost. Here it is, we also collected various links, because lots of open access resources nowadays available. You can collect these links, and by using Google custom search engine, you can add this link to the particular custom search engine. You will just read in the Google what is Google custom search engine. One by one, you can add this link to the Google custom search engine, and automatically the resources will be retrieved. If you search with any keyword, automatically the resources will be retrieved from the collected contents, key contents. So here I have used this also as a Google custom search engine. If we search something, automatically the content is retrieved from this open access resources as well as these commercial resources. So here in our university, this subscribe AR online, Care Business and Current Affairs, Denlet online, Kane online, JSTO, LexisNexis, Manupatra, SCC online, South Eastern Archive, BSU. These are very costly databases, and we invest 30 lakhs per annum to subscribe these electronic databases in our library. So it is very difficult for individual or for low-funded colleges. And there are some individual membership also, there are provisions in some of their commercial databases. And that is why we has taught, our university has taught, of giving membership to the organizations who cannot afford to purchase and subscribe this electronic database. So because 30 lakhs, investing 30 lakhs per year is a very costly affair for a particular institute. So if you take the institutional membership of our university, I think by paying 5,000 rupees, you will give an entire membership detail here. This institutional membership application form is there. And also individual membership, institutional membership, you can have the membership of our university. Institutional membership, you will have to pay, I think, 5,000 rupees. And for the individual membership, 2,500. And in 5,000 rupees, you would be able to access the services of our university. If you would like to see, I would also show some of the databases like AIR Online. So Bar Council of India has made it mandatory for all the academic institutes to go for AIR Online. AIR Online basically contains, this is the interface of the AIR Online, and it basically contains the journals and its production on All India Reporter production. My network is very poor here, and I cannot open these things. You can see the interface here. So you will be able to search by any kind of keyword here in the search box. This is the interface of AIR Online. And coming to the SCC Online interface, SCC Online is a very widely used database among the university and college university and colleges. And basically, this electronic resource covers Indian case law, Supreme Court of India cases, federal courts, and Privy Council 1950 onwards, then all the high court judgments, district court judgments, etc. So, and this cost around 2.5 to 3 lakhs. Network is very slow here. See, you can see this subjects, these reports, you can browse according to judgment by court tribunals. You can browse action rules. You can browse articles. You can browse secondary materials as well. Birender?
Madam?
Yeah, yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, okay. So, I think you can see my screen also.
Yes, yes, yes.
So, these are the, this is the interface of SAP Online, SAP Dashboard, and you can search any kind of keyword if you want to search any judgment and cases. You can search here by clicking in the search option. You can click by clicking in the search option, you can type any keyword there and you will be able to search the SAP Online database. So I will not go one by one because it will take some more lots of time, and also my internet is not also helping me out because my network is very poor. You can see. I would also suggest to go for Ishodhindu website because Ishodhindu website. Ishodhindu, here you will get lots of information regarding resources and also the webinar. Nowadays for the COVID pandemic situation, they have been conducting webinar series, and you just visit this site. It will be very beneficial for you, and you will also be able to see free resources from various publishers in this site. And also you can go very Harvard Law University site where you will get lots of free legal international resources. It will be very helpful for you. Already I have told that you can have our membership. We also have a plagiarism detection software. We have signed MOU with Infinet, and we got the access to Ubuntu. Also, we subscribe Turnitin, and Turnitin costs around 4 lakhs rupees. It's a very much costly software. So if you would like to have any kind of help regarding this, if you take membership of our university, we can help you in these services. We can also extend the services to the member in institutes. So, Virender, I think my time is over.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
So I will not take much time. Thank you so much for giving this opportunity to me, to Dr.
So, thank you, Kunkara, madam.
Yeah. So, okay. I would like to extend my thanks to Dr. Gargi, Dr. Paul, Madam, Principal, Dispur Law College, and also General Secretary, Assam College Library Association, Dr. Prakanta Kumar Deka, all the resource persons, as well as all the faculty members, research scholars, other academic staff present in this webinar. I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks for your presence, and would like to extend thanks to Dr. Virendra Pal as and Pallavi Nev, both the coordinators, for choosing such a wonderful topic considering this pandemic situation. And thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Kankana, madam. It's a great honor for us to hear you. we know that you are very much busy, then also you have given your time for us. So thank you. So next, we'd like to move to the next part of our program, that is called awareness on certain e-resources. Respected participants, that will be taken by me. I'm Dr. Virendra Pal, and we will be talking on some of the basic things like Swayam. We'll be talking about Swayam Prabha. Just we'll see the live demo, how to go to this website. And I think many of you might be aware about all these things. Just this is just for the awareness purpose. And there was a small demand from your end, like Google Classroom, how to create your Google Classroom. We will also show a 20 minutes presentation, how to create a Google Classroom. Then we'll move to the next part. That is the online examination system that will be taken by Dr. Nikhil Hazarika. So I'll just share my screen. Dr. Nikhil Hazarika, is my screen is visible to you?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. So this is the Google platform. Now we will go to the Swayam platform directly. Respected participants, you know that Swayam is a platform of e-learning where not only you can learn, but also you will get certification system. And all the major bodies of India like AICT, CEC, IGNU, IIMBM, NCERT, NEOS, MITER, NPTEL, all these bodies are working on their own domain to provide different courses on different topics. And see, what you will want to know about Swayam. Swayam is a platform of e-learning where you can learn from class 9 to till post-graduation level. And it is an MHRD project. And there are four quadrants in Swayam. Four quadrants means four parts in our learning materials. You can say visual access, you'll find it. You'll find it reading materials like in the form of PDF files. Then also you'll get some self-assessment tests or quiz. And then last, there is a discussion forum. So these are the major bodies. AICT is for technical background. NPTEL is for engineering. UGC is for post-graduation. CEC is for undergraduate education. NCERT is for school education. NEOS is for, again, open schooling. In this way, all these organizations are working on their own domain. Now see, the basic importance of Swayam comes when the MHRD gives this credit transfer. That means from any universities now you can do your courses and that marks you can incorporate into your own mark sheets. This is the guideline of Ministry of Human Resource Development on MOOCs guideline. Again, University Grant Commission has also given this guideline. AICT has also given this guideline how to incorporate your marks from other universities into your own universities. Since this is a guideline for developing online MOOCs courses. Suppose you are a faculty member and you want to develop your own MOOCs courses, then you can also develop your own MOOCs courses. There are certain guidelines how to start your project, how to make the technical things. These guidelines are also available here. There is a mobile application of Swayam. You can download the mobile application directly to your mobile phone from here. Also from you can download from the Play Store. Just type there Swayam. Now I will show you, these are the old courses. Old courses means what are the courses that are available under Swayam now. Yes. See, there you will get two options. This is the upcoming courses and these are the ongoing courses. Upcoming courses means those courses which are going to be conducted in future. You can go and you can enroll you for these courses. Suppose you want to go for any courses, then you just go on that courses and you enroll yourself for that particular course. And another option you will find, this is the ongoing courses. Ongoing courses means these courses are already continuing, but you cannot enroll, but you can use this study materials for your learning purpose in this ongoing courses option. The basic important thing I'll show you, SWAYAM is not only limited to English language now. It has been extended to other regional languages of India like Bengali, Gujarati, Hindi, Kannada, Malayalam, Marathi, Tamil. In this way, different courses are there. You can go and you can explore these courses according to your requirement. So these are the courses you can access through this platform. And these are the different books you can see from here. Another thing I will show you, this is the completed courses. Completed courses means these courses, again, these courses are completed now. This learning materials, you can use it for your learning purpose now. Just select any other of the subjects. Suppose if you want any topic on, suppose I will show you, suppose on physics, then in this way you can learn it. Similarly, other disciplines also you can access from here. But the best important thing what I want to show you is that this let COVID-19 not stop your learning, continue with SWAYAM. And this is the most important part what SWAYAM is doing right now for this COVID situation. They have categorized entire learning materials of MHRD into a single platform, what I want to say. If you are from engineering background, then you go to this option. If you are from non-engineering background, then you go to this option. And even for school educations, this resources has been categorized, it has been indexed, you can access from this platform. I will show you the basically the non-engineering courses. And see, if you are from post-graduation level, then you go to these options. And if you are from undergraduate level, then you go to these options. Suppose I will show you. Crime and society, suppose. If you want to explore some resources on crime and society, then you can explore from here. Just you go to this model, you just select crime and society introduction. Then this is the e-text. E-text means the learning materials prepared by expert on this topic. You can access this, you can download this e-text for your learning purpose. Similarly, there is self-learning material. The self-learning material, you can watch this for your learning purpose in the form of video.
From the ancient periods, crime has always been an integral part of the society. With the passage of time, crimes have not only multiplied, but also have proliferated.
Similarly, there are different topics you can use it. Suppose law and justice in globalizing world. You can explore from here. Again, different topics on, like if you want to access on corporate law, then you can access from here. This is corporate law and you select, suppose like business organization and corporate personality. Just if you can explore this learning materials and you can download this learning materials. So this is the e-text about this corporate law. Then if you want to explore this video, then you can watch this video and just play it.
Welcome to week one of MOOC's corporate law course. In this week, we will discuss about business organizations, corporate personality, and then discuss about sole proprietorship, Hindu undivided family, cooperative societies, partnerships, and the company. And
so this is all about different topics. Again, if you want to access some other topics, you can access all these things, like access to justice also. This is also available here. So when you access by yourself, then you'll definitely be benefited. This is the video. I'll not play this video, just I'll show you. So in this way, there are lots of subjects, contents available you can access through this SWAYAM platform. This, in this part, this is not for doing any course. This is only for learning. You will not get certification for these courses. This is only for learning purpose. For certification, you have to enroll for these courses, which I have shown earlier in this live demo. And the important thing, what I want to show you, is the registration in SWAYAM. See, in SWAYAM, first of all, you have to register yourself to go. You go to this option, sign in option. It's very simple. You can sign in using your Gmail account. You can use it your Facebook account. Also, if you have some Microsoft account, then you can directly sign in any of these. It's very simple. Generally, we have Google account with everyone. So we are signing with these options. Once you sign in, then you go for all courses option and you enroll yourself. Directly, you cannot enroll. First of all, you have to sign in the SWAYAM platform. Then you go to this option, all courses, and then you join the courses. Two process. That is, once you have to sign in, second, you have to join the course. That's finished. Sign in is a single process, and joining the course means every time when you join some courses, then you have to join. This is all about SWAYAM, respected participants. And you might be thinking that what is the examination system in SWAYAM? See, there is a proctored examination system. Proctored examination system means you have to sit in the examinations. Generally, proctored examination systems are nowadays it is conducted under National Testing Agency, NTA, and the SWAYAM platforms, all the examinations are conducted through this National Testing Agency platforms. And also, if you are a faculty member, sometimes we have to go to refresher courses physically in the different HRDC centers of India. Now, in SWAYAM, this facility is also available. You can do your online refresher program, that is called ARPIT, A-R-P-I-T. ARPIT means Annual Refresher Program in Teaching, and you have to follow this course for I think 80 or 84 days. Then you have to sit in examination, that is called proctored examination, conducted under National Testing Agency like CBSE NET or like entrance of Delhi Universities or JNUs. So just you sit, and the mark sheet of those refresher course is equivalent to the physical refresher course. There is no any difference. MHRD has clearly notified this, and even Government of Assam, Directorate of Higher Education, has given this guideline very clearly. So this was all about SWAYAM. Respected participants, we'll move to the next part. SWAYAM was the platform of e-learning with certification. Now I will show you SWAYAM Prabha. See, these two words are quite similar to you, but there is a difference between SWAYAM and SWAYAM Prabha. SWAYAM Prabha is a group of 32 DTH channels. That means it is quite related with your television now. If you have DD disc at your home, if you have Dish TV at your home, then by sitting at your home, you can watch different educational videos. See, there are 32 channels, and there are channels allocations. And each discipline has been assigned to different channels. You can explore this from here. An important thing in the SWAYAM part, in the SWAYAM Prabha part, is that you see the website is a bit slow. Yes, now. See, these are the current program which are going on right now in your television now. And if you want to select any of these channels, you can select and you can get the information on that particular topic or on the particular discipline. And the thing is that if you see this repeat time, this repeat times means this same program is telecasted 5 times in a day. Suppose if you miss somehow, then this courses you can watch on that particular day in another time. This facility is also available. And what are the upcoming courses? You can find it here. And what are the archive courses? Archive courses means that all the courses which are already been watched, already been telecasted in the television. Now, if you want to watch those past videos also, you can watch from this archive videos. You go to this archive option, then you will definitely able to access those learning materials here. And there is an option called frequently asked questions. Frequently asked questions will help you to know more about what is Swayamprabha. Many of us might be thinking that Swayam and Swayamprabha is same, but this difference, when you go to this frequently asked questions, it will be very much more clear. And there is an option called, see, what is Swayamprabha? They are given here, whether Swayam and Swayamprabha is same. No. So how it is different from Swayam, they have already given there. And what I have just told, that this facility is available in Tata Sky. Sorry, this facility is available in Dish TV and Didi Dish. Right now, Tata Sky or Airtel TV, they are not providing the services. These are the MHRD channels available under Didi Dish and Dish TV now. This have clearly mentioned. And channel, from channel number 2001 onwards, you will able to access in the Dish TV. 2001 onwards, if you go, then you'll find these channels in the Dish TV, like MHRD channels. So there is a process called registration. Now, why this registration is important? This will help you, or this will give alert message to you. If you want to access some educational videos on particular topic, then they will give you alert based on your requirement. So you can go and you can do your registration also. So this was all about Swayamprabha. So respected participants, we have learned about Swayam, which is an e-learning portal with certification. We have learned about Swayamprabha. It is a group of 32 DTH channels. Now we will be looking at the NDL platform, Write Life, National Digital Library of India. And see, this is the platform of National Digital Library of India, what Dr. Konkana Madam has said in her presentation, and what we have shown through this. If you are from school education, you go to this. See, for law, there is a special category has been categorized. So in this way, you can access all the law materials from here. There is the question papers. See, law question paper, Dispur Law College. This is available now. So I will not show you. Just, this is my intention, is not to figure out any college. So we are very lucky that we are under the platform of Dispur Law College right now, and we are accessing NDL resources of Dispur Law College. And these are the scholarly publications, or you can browse different data sets, you can browse different ebooks, journal papers in this platform. Now, what is the important thing, what I will to show you, you can customize this NDL platform according to your own language. Suppose we are from Assam, so in Assamese language, we can see it. We can do it according to your own regional languages as given in the NDL platform. For the new learner, you have to log in first time and you have to register. It will take hardly 30 to 40 seconds or hardly 1 minute. You just register. Once you register, then an activation mail will be sent to your registered mail. You have to activate your mail, and then you can use your login account. See, this is my login account. If I want to show you, 295404. First of all, I have registered myself, then I have now activated, and then I have login now. Now I am login as Virendra Pal. You can see it from here. Now you can access lots of learning materials from this platform now. Now what is my intention is to show is that if you are from institute should basically appoint a nodal officer in their institute. There is an option called frequently asked questions, and there is a user management. Under user management, they have given this guideline that this, how would like to register all the members of my institute. So they have given this answers also, that this can be done through institutional membership. A person from your institute called institutional nodal officer, nodal person, can take the responsibility of getting all the persons of institute registered in NDLI. That means you have to appoint a person from institute who will take the different information of the faculty members and the students, and they will contact with the NDLI, and then your NDLI account will be approved. The benefit of institutional registration is that you may get access to more resources than the individual users. So this is the basic benefit, because some of the publishers like Elsevier or Skyfinders or any publishers may not give access to those resources to the individual member. They may give access to these resources through NDLI to the institutional members. There may be chances. So in this way, you can go and you can learn, get the ideas from here. So this was all about NDL. Now I will show you the Sodh Ganga. So this is the platform again where you will get the theses of the Indian universities. Now it is mandatory for the universities to upload their theses in the Sodh Ganga platform. Every universities have to upload this. This website is a bit slow since yesterday. So when it works, I'll show you. Now I will move to the next part, that is called EPG Pathshala. This is another important platform of EPG Pathshala. And see, in this platform, you will get access to different learning materials. This is the student's corner. You just go and you can access the different learning materials. I have seen law here yesterday. 462 learning materials are available under law discipline now. Just you select any of this topic, like I want some information on advanced jurisprudence, and you select your module like a concept of jurisprudence, anything, whatever you want. Just you select systems of law, a comparison, and see, you will get this e-text. E-text means the text prepared by expert on this particular topic. Then you will get the learn more option, that means bibliography type. It will guide you to go further reading. Then self-learning. Self-learning means the video. You can watch this video and you can learn by your own. So I will not go detail, just you can watch it. Now see what I was talking about Sodh Ganga now. See, it is working, and see all the theses of the universities of India, you can find it. You just go, see, even from Assam Downtown University is here, Don Bosco University is here, Guwahati University, Dibrugarh University, and all the universities, not only from Assam but from India. These are different universities, and you go to the universities and you select any one of these. Suppose if I want to show you Guwahati University, then you go to this Guwahati University, and that will show you department wise thesis of the Guwahati universities. There are more than 5,375 theses right now under Guwahati University that has been uploaded in Sodh Ganga. So you can access it. See, Department of Anthropology, Applied Science. So let me see whether law is here. 85 theses is under law now. So you can access it. You can see the title of the thesis. You can browse by researcher. You can browse by guide also. And then you can access it. Now, right now it is not working. Some network problem. Yes, it is coming now. So you see, my intention is not to figure out any of the person or any of the thesis. Just this is for information, and this is for the awareness. I am showing this. So this is the thing about Sodh Ganga. So I will move to the next part, open access journals. Now, open access journals are the free resources which are freely available in internet. I will show you some of the websites like DOAJ. This is called Directory of Open Access Journals. Directory of Open Access Journals. Here, all the open access journals available in the world, you can access it from a single platform. That means it is not possible for a member to remember all the open access journals name. So it is recommended you go to this directory of open access journals and you can access it. See, law is also having a special category where 3000 some reports are there. You can access it. What to better understand this directory, just I will cite an example. Suppose in India there are 400 universities, suppose. So it is not possible for a person to go each and every university. It will take some more time. He may not have access to all the universities. So what the person will do, he will go to the UGC website, and then from there he will within a single platform he will access all the universities website. So similarly, directory of open access journal is doing, it is indexing all the open access journals of the world, and from this you can go to the website of individual open access website. And journal is basically research paper, primary information source. Now I will show you another source called directory of open access books, where all the open access books of the world are indexed into a single platform. You can access from this site. So philosophy of directory of open access books and directory of open access journals is quite same. The content is different. It was earlier it was for journal, now it is for books. I will show you another website, Project Gutenberg. Here you can access to different ebooks. You can download these ebooks for learning purpose. And in every program, we are just not only confined to higher education. I want to convey some important information through this platform. If you give this information to school colleagues, like we can also access the school ebooks also through NCERT platform. Then you go to this NCERT website and you can access the learning materials or books, you can say, from the NCERT website directly. You just select the class and then subject, and then it will give you. Again, I will show you one important information that should be communicated to the school colleagues, like Diksha app, which is also very important. Our honorable education minister is always giving importance to this. So you go and you download this Diksha app. It is also very important for the school educations, a platform for school education. So this was all about resources. I have shown you the Swayam, which is an e-learning portal with certification. I have shown you Swayam Prabha. It is a group of 32 DTH channels. I have shown you the National Digital Library, where you can access lots of e-resources. I have shown you Sot Ganga, where you can find PhD theses of the universities. I have shown you ETG Parsala, where you get the learning materials. I have shown some open access e-resources websites. And we are not covering NLIST here, because in law colleges we don't find NLIST e-resources too much. So we are going to the next part, Google Classroom. It is not a training, but I will show you just a small presentation how to create a Google Classroom with your personal account. Dr. Nikhil Hazariga. Dr. Nikhil Hazariga.
Yes, Brenda.
Yes, it is visible, huh?
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay. So
Google Classroom.
So, respected participants, before going to the Google Classroom, I will show you the process of creating Google Classroom. How to create it. See, these are the steps. Teacher must have Gmail account, students must have Gmail account. Then go to the classroom option from Gmail account. Then you create your class, invite your students through email ID, through classroom code. Then join your class. Then teacher, what they have to do? Teacher will share a welcoming message. And then there are four parts: stream, classwork, people and grades. Then share your study materials, give assignments, quiz. Then students will view the study materials and submit the assignment. And at last, teacher may provide the students the grade. This is all a simple flowchart I have prepared, and I will try to show you the entire thing of 20 minutes presentation.
Hi friends, today we are going to learn a new topic called Google Classroom for teachers and students. Here you will know how to create your Google Classroom using the internet connection. It's very simple. If you follow my video, you will be able to make your own. So without wasting much time, let us start. But before starting,
Dr. Nikhil Hazariga. Dr. Nikhil Hazariga. Nikhil Hazariga, please. Nikhil, da?
Yes, Binder.
The video was playing, na?
No? Yes, it's playing.
Yeah. I want to confirm.
Sorry? To clear that, now you should have an internet connection for making Google Classroom. It's something like a virtual classroom. Students and teachers can participate together, where different kinds of assignments, different kinds of academic works can be performed. So let us learn one by one. What we have to do, we have to follow certain steps. I will show you the steps one by one. First step is that the teachers must have a Gmail account. There is two kind of account. One is the teacher account, another is the student's account. Students also must have a Gmail account. I already mentioned that we need internet connection for this. What we'll do after having the Gmail account, you go to the classroom option from the Gmail account. Then you create your class. After that, the teacher will invite the students either through the email ID or there will be certain classroom code which the teacher will share with the students, and students will join through this classroom code. After this, what the students will do? Students will join the class directly through the Gmail account since the teacher has sent the request, and also the students may join the class through the classroom code which the teacher has shared. Now, after this, the teacher will share a welcoming message, and there are four menus options we can say, which is stream, classwork, people, and grade, which is self-explanatory, but I will show you. Then what the teacher will do, it will share the study materials, it will share the assignments, different kinds of videos, and other academic resources. And what the student will do, he will view the study materials, he will submit the assignments, and at last, the teacher will provide the grade. And also, if any kind of pending works will be there, then the teacher will check in his account. So let us learn practically what we have to do. We have to go to our Gmail account. You need Google Chrome browser for login. Then you go to this option called Classroom. I will show you where this option is there. This option will be there at the right side. You will see different options, and you will see the option called Classroom. When you click the Classroom, it will take you to a new page where you will see a online classroom. Now, what the teacher will do, he will continue with his email ID, and then he will create the class. He will not join the class, and we have to verify this, that whether you are with your teacher account or not. Sometimes Google browser may have different kinds of accounts. It is synchronizing from this account to this that account. So we have to be very careful about this. Now the teacher will create the class. He will not join the class. Students will join the class, and teacher will create the class. When you click the option create, then you have to accept the agreements, and then you have to continue. After that, you have to give the details of your classes, then you create it, and then now your classroom is ready. Now what you have to do, you have to now invite your students. Who are your students now? See, this is the code you can share with your students. This code, if you share, then they will definitely join the classes. Also, you can invite the students through the email ID, which is I'm going to show. Now, what the teacher will do, he will go to the option people, and he may invite another teacher also, because since it is not possible for one teacher to complete entire classes, so he may invite another teacher, and similarly he will invite the students. So he has invited the students to his class, and what the student will do now, he will log in to his account now. The teacher work is finished, now he has invited the students, and the students have to accept the request of the teacher now. For this, students will log in to his account, and he will join the class. Once the students log in to his account, he will go to the classroom option. He will accept the request, join. And after that, he will get that particular class which is created by the teacher, that is Library and Information Science. He will continue as from his email ID. And see, now the student is connected with the teacher now. Similarly, you can invite n numbers of students to your classes. Now, I will also show how to share your classroom code. The students will, what he will do, he will log into his account. He is a new student and teacher has not shared the account. So, he will go to the option classroom and he will continue. And he will go to the option plus symbol, that is create symbol, and he will join the classes. Say this is the option, classroom option. After going through this option, he will go to the option create option, which is the plus symbol. Again, I'm repeating, and then he will join the classes through this code, classroom code, which is already shared by the teacher through different media. Once he has given the code, then he will be connected to that particular class, that is Library and Information Sciences. That means two types of connections is already there. One is email ID and another is what? The code. Now you go to the teacher account again. What the teacher will do now? He will check the two students are already connected now. So now he will start his academic work now. If he want to remove some students, he can remove it. Otherwise, he can let it be as it is. Again, he can invite some more students in this way. This is my own name. So I think it's very simple. Now we will see how the teacher will share the academic resources like assignments, quiz. Till now we have seen all these things that students have joined the classes. First of all, the teacher will share a welcoming message now. Then, after sharing the welcoming message, the students will receive this message through their own account. When they will log into their account, then they can see these messages. Then the teacher starts his works. What he will do? He will go to the option create, and there are different options like assignments, quiz assignments, and different options. Now he will also assign the grades to the students. Here the teacher will have different options like to-do list, then calendar, stream, classwork, people, and grades. What he will do, he will go to the classwork and he will go to the option create. And he will start creating his assignment. Once he will click the assignment option, then he will have to give the title of the assignment, then the instructions, and at the same time, he may decide the point, what will be the total marks of the assignment. He may also ungrade this without any grade. Then it may have some time limit for submitting the assignments. He may decide it. After that, no students can submit the assignments. Then he will assign the topic. Then what the teacher will do, he may add the different links. He may also attach different files from his Google Drive account. Similarly, he may attach different links. Also, he may attach different files and also some YouTube videos. So let us see how he will upload the file from his local computer. Already the teacher has made an assignment and he has uploaded the assignment. And then again, what he will do, he will give the link for a YouTube video now. Students can view this file. There are different options. He will add a link for the YouTube video. You may directly search the YouTube video and you may add it. Now the students may see this video and also he may complete his assignment by looking through this video. What the teacher will do now, he may also make a schedule that this assignment should be published tomorrow. Not today, I am not going to give the assignment, but tomorrow, since I don't have time, so I will make a schedule that tomorrow morning this assignment will be reached to the students. So you may also do that one also. You may fix the time and then you just schedule it. But right now we will go to the option assign option. As soon as you give the assign option, the assignment will reach to the students directly. Now what the student will do, he will log in to his account, student's account. This is the assignment that has been given by the teacher. Since still we are in teacher account, now he will log out from his account. Now students will log into his account from his home and he will check it. And he has seen that, oh, the teacher has given some works. He will open it. Then what he will do, he will check the assignment document. There are certain questions given by his teacher. And also he may view the video. After this, he will prepare his assignments. And then he will upload from his account and then he will submit to the teacher directly. See, there is a schedule which is the last date for the assignment and the total marks is already mentioned there, 20 points. Now he will add and then he will attach his file. Now question has arrived, now it is his duty to give the answer. He will select the answer from his local computer. And then he will submit to the teacher. He will on this option, turn in option. Unless and until if you don't on this option, then this assignment will not reach to the teacher. So after submitting, you have to turn it on option by the students. This is the response by the students. And he will on this option, turn in, which is very important after submitting your assignment. Otherwise your assignment may not be submitted to the teacher. Now what the teacher will do, he will open his account, that means Gmail account and Google Classroom account. Yes, this is another student who is submitting his assignment. Since we have created two students, and then now it is the time of the teacher to check the assignments because the students has viewed the study materials and he has already submitted the assignment. Now the teacher will go to the to-do list. To-do list means the pending works. If he is having any pending works, he will check here. Then he will turn in options. He will check it, the assignments of the students one by one. And then he will provide the grade according to the performance of the students. He is also providing the grade to the both the students. And then he will return the grade to the students. Once the grade is returned by the teacher, the students may check this from their own account, from their students' account, and then they will able to know what grade has been assigned by the teacher to them. I will show you. So he will log out. Teacher will log out from his system now, and the students' work is started here. Students will also check from the to-do list, and then he will see, oh, this is the grade given by the teacher, 20/12. So in this way, the grading of the marks can be done by the teachers, and that can be checked by the students from the students' account. Now, the teacher will again check to-do list that there are two students that has already been graded. Now the end task will be to mark as reviewed. Unless and until if you don't give this, your teacher work will not be finished here. He have to complete this option mark as reviewed. Then only there will be no any pending work from the teacher's account. Now, you may also upload a theme. The teacher may upload a picture of his classroom, and then he may also check the different grading points of the students and can download in Excel format also. Now I will show you how to make a quiz from the Google Classroom directly using the Google Docs, that is Google Form. Now he will go to the option quiz, and he will make the title of the quiz, and then what he will do, he will add different links, he may add different files. Similarly, the case with the previous, he may assign the points, total marks of the quiz 20. He may also ungrade this. He may limit the students, which students should participate in the quiz. And then he may also decide the last date of the quiz sometimes. But generally in quiz, there is a fixed session of time. Time is common for everyone in quiz. So just for the example, I'm showing this. It's better to make a schedule for a quiz. And then he will go to the option of Google Form as blank quiz. The blank form of Google will show here. What the teacher will do, he will give certain questions, predefined questions, and also he will give different multiple options for the questions, and he will set the answer as predefined so that after giving the response by the students, they can check whether they have correct answer or not. So the options is already given by the teacher. Now teacher is preparing the quiz form now, which the student has to answer. And then he will assign the marks to each questions for the quiz. From this lower button, answer key, he will give the right answer. And also he will assign the points for each questions, and then done. He will click the correct answer, and then he will make done. If you have any feedback, then you may add it, otherwise leave it blank. Similarly, he will add another questions to his Google form, and also he will assign the points for the particular questions. Since it is my own college, so I should acknowledge it. And then he will assign the points, and then done. Now the creating of form, that means creation of form activity is completed by the teacher. And he will assign this quiz to the students now. Once the teacher has assigned this, the students may be able to see from their account. Now students will log into their account and then they will go to the to-do list. If there are any pending works, they will check it from their account. And then they will reply. Once they will open it, they will see the link of the Google form. Once they click it, they will see the question patterns and they may select the answers. Since we have already decided the predefined points, as soon as the student has submitted his response, he will get the marks immediately. After submitting, once he will see the view score option, then he may be able to see how much score he has secured. Out of 20, he has secured 10 points. Now, what the teacher will do, teacher will check it accordingly. So these are the steps. Again, I'm reviewing. The teacher must have a Gmail account, students must have a Gmail account, and then they will go to the classroom option. Teacher will go to the classroom option for creating the class, and the students will go to the classroom option for joining the class. Students may join through two processes: one through the invitation of the students through email ID, and also through sharing the classroom code by the teacher, and the students will enter the code to his classroom, which is already shown in this video. And then the teacher will give a welcoming message. Then there are different options which I have already shown you. Then the teacher will share the study materials, assignments, quiz, different kinds of academic resources. And then students, what they will do, they will view the study materials and then accordingly they will submit the assignments. And the teacher will lastly grade the students, and then he will check the to-do list whether there is any pending works or not. And at the very last, he has to complete the option mark as reviewed. Then only the work of teacher is completed. So this is all about Google Classroom. I hope you have enjoyed.
So I hope you have seen this presentation, and so this is the end part from my side. Now I would like to invite our next resource person, Dr. Nikhil Hazariga sir, to give his presentation. Dr. Hazariga sir, I am audible to you?
Yes.
Dr. Hazariga,
thank you.
Yes, yes.
Yes, Vena.
Yes, yes. Please, sir, continue.
Yes. Thank you, Vendra.
Welcome, sir.
Vendra, my screen is
visible. Yes, sir, visible. Yes.
Yes, visible. Yes, yes, yes. This is visible. How to conduct online exams?
Yes, yes,
yes. Yes, yes. My dear participant. Principal sir, Brenda, Pakhantada, Kankana, I would like to start my live demonstration on how to conduct online exam using Google Form. There are so many videos, and there are so many videos and lectures in YouTube in both English and Hindi. So
I am trying to make these classes in mixed languages, both English, Hindi, and Assamese. Okay, participant. Brinda, I am audible?
Yes, sir.
যোৱাকালি এটা মই অনলাইন এক্সাম দিছিলোঁ গ্ৰুপত 25 মাইক অফ আছে ন কমিউনিকেট বহুত চাইড কমিউনিকেট কৰিব নোৱাৰিম
নাই অসুবিধা হ'ব অলপ মানে
পাৰ্টিচিপেণ্ট সকল এতিয়া আপোনালোকে 25 পাৰ্টিচিপেণ্টে এই এক্সামটো দিছিলে এতিয়া আমাৰ সুবিধা হৈছে কি আমাৰ ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলে ইজি প্ৰচেছটো বিচাৰে মোবাইলটোতে সকলো বিচাৰে ৰিংটো গুগল ক্লাছৰুমটো এটা বহুত ভাল বস্তু তেনেকৈ টেলেণ্ট এলএমএছ বহুত ভাল বস্তু কিন্তু আমাৰ ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলে ইমান ভিতৰলৈ যাব নিবিচাৰে ওপৰতে বিচাৰে লিংকটো লাগে জাষ্ট হোৱাটছএপৰ লিংকটো লাগে এতিয়া আমি কি কৰিছোঁ এই কভিড পিৰিয়ডত আমাৰ আমি এটা এম চি কিউ টাইপ বেষ্ট ছেশ্যনেল এক্সাম বা টাৰ্মিনেল এক্সাম পাতিব পাৰোঁ সেইটো কাৰণে আমাৰ কি হয় গুগল ফৰ্ম লাগিব এটা গুগল ফৰ্মটো আমি বনাবলৈ যি অলৰেডি ব্ৰেইনলৈ দেখুৱাইছে যে গুগল ফৰ্ম কেনেকৈ ক্ৰিয়েট কৰে সেই গুগল ফৰ্মটোকে কেনেকৈ মই এক্সামিনেশ্যন ছিষ্টেমত ইউজ কৰে কুইজত ইউজ কৰে তাকে মই দেখুৱাব বিচাৰোঁ আৰু ইয়াত এটা বিউটিফুল বস্তু আছে যে অট'মেটিকেলি চেকিং হৈ যায় কোনে কিমান নম্বৰ পাইছে মাৰ্কছবিলাক ওলাই যায় আৰু সেইটো কাৰণে আমাৰ একো প্ৰব্লেম নহয় গতিকে পাৰ্টিচিপেণ্টসকল মই এতিয়া আগবাঢ়িছোঁ যদি আপোনালোকে শুনি আছে যদি আপোনালোকে ভাবিছে যে এই বন্ধৰ পিৰিয়ডত আপোনালোকে এটা সৰু এম চি কিউ বেছ এক্সাম পাতিব ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলৰ তেনেহ'লে আপোনালোকে কুইকলি যিহেতু মই আপোনালোকক শুনা নাই আপোনালোকে চাৰ্ট বক্সত এটা ইয়েছ বিগ ইয়েছ দি দিয়ক বা এটা বিগ ৱাই লিখি দিয়ক তেতিয়া মই গম পাম যে বহুত চাইড কমিউনিকেট হৈ আছে এতিয়া আমি যোৱাকালিৰ যিটো ফৰ্ম সেই ফৰ্মটো আমি চাব লৈছোঁ সেইটো আমি জাষ্ট অভাৰভিউ ল'বৰ কাৰণে এটা আছিলে এইটো বস্তুটো ফৰ্মখন এটা নাম আছিলে কেনেকুৱা টাইপৰ কুৱেশ্যন আহিব সেইবিলাক আছিলে স্টুডেণ্টৰ নাম ল'ব লাগে সেইখিনি আমি গোটেইখিনি কুৱেশ্যনবিলাক আমি ইয়াত পাই গৈছিলোঁ গোটেইখিনি পাই গৈছিলোঁ কুৱেশ্যনখিনি আৰু সেইকাৰণে আমাৰ কেনেকৈ ৰেছপণ্ডটো আহিছিলে 25 ৰেছপণ্ড আহিছিলে আমি গম পাই গৈছিলোঁ ছামাৰিত আহিছিলে আমাৰ স্ক'ৰ কোনে কিমান কৰিছিলে এইটো আহি গৈছে আমাৰ এয়া কোনে কিমান মাৰ্কছ পালে আহি গ'ল ইয়াৰ উপৰিও আমাৰ কি হৈছে আমি যদি মাৰ্কশ্বীট এটা উলিয়াওঁ বুলি ভাবোঁ অট'মেটিক চেকিং হৈ যাব জাষ্ট আপোনালোকে এটা অভাৰভিউ দেখুৱাই লৈছোঁ এইটো তেতিয়া কোনে কিমান মাৰ্কছ পালে আপোনালোকৰ মোৰ স্ক্ৰীণখন চাওক ওলাই যাব ইয়াৰ ইয়াৰ মাৰ্কছবিলাক ওলাইছে এইফালে নামবিলাক ওলাইছে এইফালে মাৰ্কছবিলাক ওলাইছে আৰু এইবিলাক আমি পিছত এক্সেল চিলত কৰি যাব মানে অট'মেটিকেলি এটা এক্সামৰ ইভালুৱেশ্যনো হৈ গুচি গ'ল বেণ্টা শুনি আছা
ইয়েছ ইয়েছ
এতিয়া মই আহিছোঁ আপোনালোকৰ যে কেনেকৈ এটা ফৰ্ম বনাব পাৰি মই হৈছে আপোনালোকৰ সকলোৰে জিমেইল একাউণ্ট আছে গুগল একাউণ্ট আছে ইয়াৰ কাৰণে এটা গুগল একাউণ্ট লাগিব গুগল একাউণ্টটো লাগিব গতিকে আপোনালোকে প্ৰথম এটা আপোনালোকৰ গুগল একাউণ্টত যাওক তাত চাইন ইন কৰি লওক বা জিমেইলটো খুলি লওক জিমেইলটো খুলি ল'লে আপোনালোকে স্ক্ৰীণৰ ৰাইট টপ বটম ইয়াত এটা দেখিব যে গুগল এপছ আপোনালোকৰ আইকনখনৰ ফটো আইকনখনৰ ওচৰত ধৰিব পাৰিছেনে আপোনালোকে চাৰ্টত কিবা দিছেনে নাই দিয়া ইয়াতে এটা গুগল এপছ পাব ইয়াত ক্লিক কৰি দিব কৰাৰ লগে লগে এখন আপোনাৰ মেনু ওলাই যাব গুগল এপছবিলাকৰ এটা মেনু ওলাই যাব প্ৰথমটো হ'ব নাই একাউণ্ট ওলাব এনেকৈ আহি আহি আপুনি গুগল ড্ৰাইভত যাব গুগল ড্ৰাইভত ক্লিক কৰি দিব আপোনাৰ গোটেই স্ক্ৰীণখন খোল খাই যাব খোল খাই যোৱাৰ লগে লগে আপোনাৰ লেফ্ট ছাইড টপ লেফ্ট ছাইড টপত আপোনালোকে এটা ড্ৰাইভৰ চিন পাব সেউজীয়া নীলা আৰু হালধীয়া এটা ড্ৰাইভ পাব ইয়াৰ তলতে আছে আপোনাৰ প্লাছ চিন দি নিউ আছে নিউত ক্লিক কৰিব নিউত ক্লিক কৰাৰ লগে লগে আপুনি প্ৰথম ফাইলটো পাব ফল্ডাৰ তাৰপিছতে শেষলৈ গুচি আহিব আহি মোৰ পাব মোৰ পাব মোৰত আপুনি আকৌ চুই দিব গুগল ফৰ্মছ গৈ গৈ আপুনি ব্লেংক ফৰ্ম ক্লিক অন ব্লেংক ফৰ্ম যিহেতু আমি এখন ব্লেংক ফৰ্ম বনাব গৈ আছোঁ গুগল ফৰ্মখনকে আমি এখন গুগল কুইজ কৰিম বা এখন কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰ বনাম আৰু যিখন কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰ আমি ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীৰ লিংকটো হোৱাটছএপত দি পঠিয়াব পাৰিম বা ইমেইল কৰি দি পঠিয়াব পাৰিম আৰু তেখেতলোকে সেইটো ফিল আপ কৰি দিয়ালৈকে আমি গোটেই ৰিজাল্টটো গম পাই যাম এতিয়া আপোনাৰ গোটেই ব্লেংক ফৰ্মখন খোল খাই গ'ল গতিকে আমি যিহেতু ফৰ্মখনৰ বা এক্সাম কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰখনৰ নাম এটা দিব লাগিব সেইটো কাৰণে আপুনি লেফ্ট ছাইড টপত আহি যাওক আনটাইটল ফর্ম লিখা আছে আনটাইটল ফর্ম তা ক্লিক করক ক্লিক করে আমি এটা পরীক্ষার নাম দিই ধরে লোক আমি দিছো নাম টেস্ট ফর পেপার ওয়ান আর আমি দিব পারো যে কোন সেমিস্টার বা কোন ইয়ার কারণে হয় ধরে লোক আপনার সেকেন্ড সেমিস্টার সেমিস্টার সেকেন্ড সেমিস্টার ইয়াত আমার কি হল গোটে এক্সামপল গোটে ডিটেলস ডেসক্রিপশন তো আহি গেল যে সেকেন্ড সেমিস্টার পেপার ওয়ানের কারণে আমি টেস্টটা পাতিছো আর এই করার পিছত আপনি অটোমেটিক সেভ হবে যেহেতু আমি গুগল লাইভত কামখিনি করেছো অটোমেটিক সেভ হবে আপনি এক্সট্রাকে সেভ করব দরকার নাই আর আমি মেইন ফর্মখন আহি আকো ইয়াত বেলেগে টাইপ করব লাগে ইয়াত ডাবল ক্লিক করে দিও গোটেটা গুছিয়ে আহিল আপনার টেস্ট ফর পেপার ওয়ান সেকেন্ড সেমিস্টার ব্রেন শুনি আছা
ইয়েস ইয়েস
এইটো দিলো আমি কোয়েশ্চন পেপারখনৰ নামটো দিলো টাইটলটো দিলো ইয়াত আমি লিখিব পাৰোঁ ফৰ্ম ডেসক্ৰিপশ্যনত আমি লিখিব পাৰোঁ যে এইটো এম চি কিউ বেছড এক্সাম এম চি কিউ বেছড এক্সাম লিখিব পাৰোঁ আৰু আমি যিখিনি ইনষ্ট্ৰাকশ্যন দিব লাগে ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰী যিহেতু আমাৰ এনচাৰ শ্বীটখনৰ প্ৰথম পেজত যিখিনি ইনষ্ট্ৰাকশ্যন থাকে যে টোটেল টোটেল মাৰ্কছ 20 টাইম 30 মিনিট এনেকে আমি ডেসক্রিপশন দিব পাৰো যে ল'ৰা ছোৱালীখিনি প্ৰথম দেখাৰ লগে লগে গম পাই যে পৰীক্ষাটো কেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ হ'ব বা সময় কিমান এলট কৰা হৈছে এইটো হ'ল আমাৰ টাইটল অফ দ্য কুৱেশ্যনছ পেপাৰ এতিয়া আমি কেইটামান বস্তু ইয়াত চাবলৈ যাব লাগিব যে এই ছেটিং এইকেইটাত কি আছে যদি ব্ৰেণ্ডৰ অলৰেডি গুগল ক্লাছৰুমত দেখুৱাইছে যে এই প্লাছ চিনটো মানে আমি এনেকুৱা আৰু এটা প্লাছ কৰিম এটা কুৱেশ্যন প্লাছ কৰিম এইটো দিয়া আছে যে ইম্পৰ্ট কুৱেশ্যনছ ধৰক আপুনি এটা ছেমিষ্টাৰৰ কাৰণে এখন ফৰ্ম বনাইছে নেক্সট ছেমিষ্টাৰৰ কাৰণে এখন বনাব লাগে কেইটামান কুৱেশ্যন ইয়াতো আছে তাতো দিব লাগে গতিকে আপুনি বেলেগকৈ টাইপ কৰিবৰ কাৰণে আপুনি ইয়াৰ পৰা আপুনি ইম্পৰ্ট কৰিব পাৰিব আৰু টি টি ডাবল টি ডাবল টি এইটো আছে এট টাইটল এণ্ড ডেছক্ৰিপশ্যন ধৰক এইটো আমি এনেকুৱা ডেছক্ৰিপশ্যন তাকো তলত দিব লাগে তেতিয়া আমি ইয়াত ক্লিক কৰিব লাগিব এইটো হ'ল আমি এজ এ ইমেজ ফটো হিচাপেও আমি কিছুমান কুৱেশ্যন আপলোড কৰিব পাৰোঁ ধৰক আমি ফটো এটা দিব লাগে তাৰপিছত সুধিব লাগে যে এই ফটোটো ক'ৰ কি হয় তেতিয়া আমি ফটোটো আপলোড কৰি দিলেই হ'ল তাৰপিছত আহিলে ভিডিঅ' তেনেকৈ ঠিক আমি ভিডিঅ' আপলোড কৰিও আমি কুৱেশ্যনছ সুধিব পাৰোঁ আৰু এইটো হ'ল ছেকশ্যনছ ধৰক আমি কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰখনত কেইটামান ছেকশ্যন কৰিব লৈছোঁ ধৰক 20 নম্বৰৰ কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰখনত আমি 5টা ছেকশ্যন কৰিব লৈছোঁ বা 4টা ছেকশ্যন কৰিব লৈছোঁ 5-5কৈ আছে তেতিয়া আমি ছেকশ্যন কৰি দিব পাৰোঁ এইকেইটা আমি প্ৰথম জানি ললোঁ তাৰপিছত আমি আকৌ ওপৰত জানিব লাগিব যে এইকেইটা কি এইটো হ'ল ছেটিং চেণ্টাৰৰ ওচৰত যিটো আছে এইটো ছেটিং ইয়াত আমি ছেটিং কৰিব পাৰোঁ যে কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰটো কেনেকৈ ছেটিং কৰিম এইটো ছেটিং কৰিব লাগিব নেক্সট এইটো চকুটো যে আছে প্ৰিভিউ মানে আমি চাব ফৰ্মখন বনাই থাকোঁতে আমি চাব পাৰিম যে ফৰ্মখন কেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ হৈছে কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰটো কেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ হৈছে তাৰপিছত নেক্সট আহিল কাষ্টমাইজ থিম ধৰক আমি কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰ দেখিবৰ কাৰণে এটা থিম ল'ব পাৰোঁ ধৰক ইয়াত আমি থিমটো লৈছোঁ যে ইমেজ হেডাৰত গৈ এটা থিম লৈছোঁ ব্ৰেণ্ডত শুনি আছা আমি ধৰক ইয়াতে এটা ভাল লগা থিম লৈছোঁ এইটো থিম লৈছোঁ ইনচাৰ্ট দিছোঁ এটা আমাৰ ইয়াতে অট'মেটিকেলি আহি যাব এতিয়া থিম এটা আহি গ'ল এতিয়া অলপ ভাল লাগিছে থিম এটা আহি গ'ল ঠিক তেনেদৰে আমি কি কৰিলোঁ মই থিম কালাৰ এই কালাৰবিলাক এই যে আছে এই কালাৰবিলাক আমি চেঞ্জ কৰিব পাৰোঁ যিকোনো ব্লু ল'লোঁ আমি ব্লু হৈ গ'ল ঠিক সেইদৰে আমি আমাৰ ৱৰ্ড আখৰখিনি কেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ হ'ব ষ্টাইলটো এইটো বেছিক ষ্টাইলত আছে আমি বেলেগ বেলেগ ল'ব পাৰোঁ ফৰ্মেল ল'ব পাৰোঁ ফৰ্মেল ল'লোঁ বেলেগ হৈ গ'ল এইখিনি হ'ল আমাৰ ছেটিংছ এতিয়া আমি প্ৰথম কামটোৱে হ'ব আমাৰ যিহেতু আমি গুগল ফৰ্মটো গুগল কুইজলৈ বা গুগল এটা কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰলৈ কনভাৰ্ট কৰিব লৈছোঁ গতিকে আমি প্ৰথম ছেটিঙত যাব লাগিব জাষ্ট ছেটিঙত গ'লোঁ ছেটিঙত গৈ জেনেৰেলত আছে কি যে কালেক্ট ইমেইল এড্ৰেছ যিহেতু আমি প্ৰতিজন ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীৰ ইমেইল এড্ৰেছটো আমি কালেক্ট কৰিব লাগিব কি কাৰণে যদি আমি কালেক্ট নকৰোঁ তেতিয়া কি হ'ব এজন ছাত্ৰই দুবাৰকৈ পৰীক্ষাটো দিব সেইকাৰণে আমি কুইজৰ ক্ষেত্ৰত এইটো কৰিব লাগিব কালেক্ট ইমেইল কালেক্ট কৰিব লাগিব ইয়াত এটা ৰাইটিং দিব লাগিব আৰু আমি কৰিব লাগিব যে ৰিকুৱাৰ্ড চাইন ইন ইয়াত এতিয়া ক্লিক কৰিব লাগিব আমি যিহেতু কুইজ কৰিম বা কুৱেশ্যন কৰিম গতিকে আমি আপোনালোকে মনত ৰাখিব ছেটিঙৰ জেনেৰেলত গৈ আমি এই দুটাত ক্লিক কৰি ৰাখিব লাগিব কালেক্ট ইমেইল এড্ৰেছ এণ্ড ৰিকুৱাৰ্ড চাইন ইন লিমিট টু মানে আছে মানে এবাৰ তেখেতলোকে পৰীক্ষাটো দিয়াৰ পিছত আকৌ দুবাৰ দিব নোৱাৰে আৰু গোটেই এইবাৰ গোটেইকেইটা নোৱাৰিলেও পিছৰ পৰা চাই মেলি আকৌ দিম সেইটো দিব নোৱাৰে এবাৰেই দিব পাৰিব ঠিক তেনেদৰে আমি আহিব লাগিব প্ৰেজেণ্টেশ্যন ছেকেণ্ডটো হ'ল আমাৰ প্ৰেজেণ্টেশ্যনছ প্ৰেজেণ্টেশ্যনত আমি কি কৰিব লাগিব ইয়াত আপোনাৰ তিনিটা বক্স আছে তিনিটা বক্সৰ আমি মাজৰটো ক্লিক কৰি থ'ব লাগিব যে চেপল কুৱেশ্যন অৰ্ডাৰ মানে কি হৈছে বহুত ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীয়ে কি কৰে যে আমি দহটা কুৱেশ্যনছ দিওঁ তেখেতলোকে কোনোবা এক্সপাৰ্ট ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীয়ে পাৰি গ'ল পাৰি থকাৰ পিছত হোৱাটছএপত গোটেই এনচাৰ শ্বীটটো দি দিয়ে যে কুৱেশ্যন নাম্বাৰ ওৱান এ কুৱেশ্যন নাম্বাৰ টু চি কুৱেশ্যন নাম্বাৰ থ্ৰী ডি তেনেকৈ দি দিয়ে গতিকে আমাৰ যেতিয়া কুৱেশ্যনবিলাক আমি যেতিয়া এই অপশ্যনটো ৰাখিম ছেকেণ্ড অপশ্যনটো ৰাখিম চেপল কুৱেশ্যন অৰ্ডাৰ তেতিয়া কুৱেশ্যনবিলাক প্ৰতিজন ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীৰ কাৰণে বেলেগ বেলেগ এটা চিৰিয়েলত যাব কাৰোবাৰ ওৱান টু কাৰোবাৰ টেনত যাব কাৰোবাৰ টেন টু কাৰোবাৰ এইটত যাব গতিকে তেখেতলোকে সেইটো কৰিব নোৱাৰে গতিকে যিহেতু আমি কুইজ কৰিছোঁ গতিকে চেপল কুৱেশ্যনছ অৰ্ডাৰত আমি ক্লিক কৰি ৰাখিম প্ৰেজেণ্টেশ্যনো অকল আমি এটাই মাজৰটোৱে ক্লিক কৰি ৰাখিম নেক্সট আহিলে আমাৰ কুইজ এইটো মেইন ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট বস্তু ইয়াত আমি সদায় মেক দিছ কুইজ এইটো আমি চেক কৰি থ'ব লাগিব তো গ্ৰীণটো হ'ব লাগিব যে মেক দিছ কুইজ এইটো আমি সদায় অন কৰি ৰাখিব লাগিব তাৰপিছত আমি যিটো এক্সাম পাতিম সেইকাৰণে কি হৈছে ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীয়ে লগে লগে এক্সামটো দিয়াৰ লগে লগে এক্সামটো দিয়াৰ লগে লগে যদি নিজৰ মাৰ্কছটো দেখে তেতিয়াহ'লে অকণমান মনত বেয়া পাব পাৰে গতিকে আমি ইয়াত এইটো কৰি থ'ম লেটাৰ যে পৰীক্ষাটো শেষ হোৱাৰ পিছত আমি আধা ঘণ্টাৰ কাৰণে পৰীক্ষাটো পাতিলোঁ তাৰপিছত আমি মাৰ্কছটো ৰিলিজ কৰিম বা আমি নটিচ বৰ্ডত লগাই দিম গতিকে ইমিডিয়েটলি আফটাৰ ৰিছাবমিশ্যন এইটো চাব নালাগে যিটো মই কালি আপোনালোকক যিখন যিটো কুৱেশ্যন কুইজ কৰিছিলোঁ তাত এইখিনি অ'পেন কৰাই ৰাখিছিল আপোনালোকে চাব পাৰিছিলে কিমান পাইছিলোঁ সেইটো চাব পাৰিছিলে নিজে কোন কোনটো কুৱেশ্যনৰ এনচাৰ কি হয় সেইটো চাব পাৰিছিলোঁ তাৰপিছত আমি আহিম যে কাৰেক্ট এনচাৰ যে ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলে যে বিশটা কুৱেশ্যনৰ এনচাৰ দিলে কোনটো শুদ্ধ হ'ল কোনটো ভুল হ'ল সেইটো যেন চাব নোৱাৰে লগে লগে পৰীক্ষা চলি থকাৰ সময়ত এইটো আমি মাজতো আনচেক কৰি থওঁ গতিকে আমি কুইজত গৈ কুইজ অপশ্যনত গৈ আমি তিনিটাই কাম কৰিম প্ৰথমটো মেক দিচ কুইজ আমি চেকিং কৰিম নেক্সটটো কৰিম যে ৰিলিজ গ্ৰেড লেটাৰ আফটাৰ মেনুৱেল ৰিভিউ সেইটো আমি চেকিং কৰিম আৰু ৰেছপণ্ডেণ্ট কেন চি ইয়াত তিনিটা অপশ্যন আছে এই তিনিটা অপশ্যনৰ ভিতৰত আমি মাজৰটো আনচেক কৰি থ'ম তাৰে কেঞ্চাৰটো তেখেতলোকে চাব নোৱাৰে ব্ৰেণ্ড ঠিকে আছে তাৰপিছত আমি গোটেই ফৰ্মখন চেভ কৰিম আমি চেভ কৰাৰ আগতে আকৌ এবাৰ আমি এই প্ৰচেছকেইটা যিহেতু ছেটিংটোৱে মেইন বস্তু ছেটিংটোৱে চাই লৈছোঁ যে প্ৰথম জেনেৰেলত আমাৰ থাকিব কালেক্ট ইমেইল এড্ৰেছ এইটো চেক কৰা থাকিব নেক্সট চেক কৰা থাকিব লিমিট টু ওৱান ৰেছপণ্ড ইয়াত দুটা বস্তুৱে চেক কৰা থাকিব দুটা নেক্সট আহিলা প্ৰেজেণ্টেশ্যনত অকল এটাই চেক কৰা থাকিব যে মাজৰটো চেপুল কুৱেশ্যন অৰ্ডাৰ কুৱেশ্যনবিলাক চেঞ্জ হৈ হৈ সকলোৰে ক্ষেত্ৰত বেলেগ বেলেগ আহিব থাৰ্ডটো হ'ল মেইন ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট এইটো হ'ল মেক দিচ কুইজ এইটো আমি অন কৰি ৰাখিব লাগিব নেক্সট লেটাৰ আফটাৰ মেনুৱেল ৰিভিউ পৰীক্ষাটো হৈ যোৱাৰ পিছতহে তেখেতলোকে গম পায় কেনেকুৱা কিমান নম্বৰ পাইছে পৰীক্ষা চলি থকাৰ পিছত ঘৰ সময়ত গম নাপায় একেবাৰে শেষৰ কামটো হ'ল যে কাৰেক্ট এনচাৰ কোনটো সেইটো পৰীক্ষা দি থকাৰ সময়ত বা ছাবমিট কৰাৰ লগে লগে যেন গম নাপায় এইটো গম পালে কি হয় তেখেতলোকে বেলেগক সহায় কৰিবলৈ যায় যে মোৰ এইটো ভুল হ'ল কিন্তু শুদ্ধটো এইটো আছে গতিকে আমি কুইজত তিনিটা অপশ্যন অন ৰাখিম সেইকেইটা হ'ল মেক দিছ কুইজ ছেকেণ্ডটো হ'ল লেটাৰ আফটাৰ মেনুৱেল ৰিভিউ এণ্ড থাৰ্ডটো হ'ল আমি এই ৰেছপণ্ডেণ্ট কেন চি মাজৰটো আনচেক কৰি ৰাখিম বাকীকেইটা চেক মিছ কোন হোৱা কুৱেশ্যন এটা এৰি গ'ল কোনটো কুৱেশ্যন এৰিলে সেইটো চাব পাৰিব বা পইণ্ট ফেলুটো হ'ল যে কোনটো কুৱেশ্যনত কিমান মাৰ্কছ আছে সেইটো চাব পাৰিব সেইটো চাবই লাগিব খালি মাজৰটো আমি আনচেক কৰি ৰাখিম একেবাৰে শেষৰ গৈ আমি এইটো কি কৰিম চেভ কৰিম ব্ৰেণ্ড শুনি আছা এতিয়া আমি আহি গ'লো যিখিনি আমাৰ ব্ৰেণ্ডই গুগল ক্লাছৰুমত শিকাইছিলে যে কুৱেশ্যনবিলাক আমি কেনেকৈ চেভ কৰিম ব্ৰেণ্ডৰ পাৰ্টিচিপেণ্ট ঠিকে আছে নে কমফৰ্টেবল মাই ডিয়াৰ পাৰ্টিচিপেণ্ট এতিয়া আমি যিটো হেডিংটোত আহি গ'লো ডেছক্ৰিপশ্যনত আহি গ'লো যে পেপাৰখনৰ নাম দিলোঁ টেষ্ট ফৰ পেপাৰ ওৱান কলন দি আমি ছেমিষ্টাৰ টু এইটো দিলে আমাৰ কি হয় যে আমি যিটো আমাৰ ষ্টুডেণ্টে যেতিয়া মেনুৱেল পৰীক্ষাবিলাকত নিজৰ ৰোল নম্বৰ লিখে ছেমিষ্টাৰ লিখে কোনখনত দিছে কি কথা এইবিলাক আমি বৰ বেছিকৈ লিখি থাকিব নালাগে কাৰণ আমাৰ কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰখনতে ওলাই গ'ল যে পেপাৰ ওৱান আৰু ছেকেণ্ড ছেমিষ্টাৰ ষ্টুডেণ্টৰ কাৰণে এইখন আপোনাৰ ফৰ্থ ছেমিষ্টাৰ ষ্টুডেণ্টৰ কাৰণে নহয় ছেকেণ্ড ছেমিষ্টাৰ ষ্টুডেণ্টৰ কাৰণে গতিকে ষ্টুডেণ্টে ছেমিষ্টাৰ কি সেইটো আকৌ লিখিব নালাগে পেপাৰখনৰ নাম কি সেইটো আকৌ লিখিব নালাগে তাৰপিছত আমি আহি গ'লো যিহেতু আমি কুইজ কৰিছিলোঁ আৰু ইমেইলটো লাগে বুলিয়ে কৈছিলোঁ সেইকাৰণে এইটো অট'মেটিকেলি ইয়াত আমাৰ আহি গ'ল ইমেইল এড্ৰেছ আহি গ'ল ভেলিড ইমেইল এড্ৰেছ আহি গ'ল ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰী ইয়াত আমাৰ ইমেইল ভৰাবই লাগিব গতিকে আমাৰ ফাৰ্ষ্ট পাৰ্টটো হৈ গ'ল। এতিয়া আমি ছেকেণ্ড পাৰ্টলৈ আহিম। ছেকেণ্ড পাৰ্টত আহিবৰ কাৰণে আমি ইয়াত ক্লিক কৰি দিলোঁ। ইয়াত আপোনাৰ আহি গ'ল বৃন্দ কোৱাৰ নিচিনাকৈ যে ইয়াত কি লাগিব। নেক্সটটো আমাৰ নিশ্চয় ডেফিনেটলি লাগিব যে ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীৰ নামটো লাগিব। ইয়াত ধৰক ফুল নেম, ফুল নেম লিখি দিলোঁ। ফুল নেম লিখি দিয়াৰ লগে লগে এইফালে চাওক ৰাইট ছাইডে অট'মেটিকেলি লৈ ল'লে যে শ্বৰ্ট এনচাৰ নামটো আমি এটা শ্বৰ্ট এনচাৰতে লিখিম। গতিকে এইখিনি ঠাইত লিখিব পাৰিব। আৰু ইয়াত আমাৰ এটা কাম কৰিম আমি যে নামটো দিবই লাগিব, সেইকাৰণে ৰিকুৱাৰ্ড, এই ৰিকুৱাৰ্ডটো আমি দি দিম। গতিকে ইয়াত এটা ষ্টাৰ চিন আহিব, আমি চাব পাৰিম ইয়াত ফুল নেম এটা ষ্টাৰ চিন আহিলে মানে এই নামটো ভৰালেহে নেক্সট ষ্টেপলৈ যাব পাৰিব। ধৰিব পাৰিছে ব্ৰেণ্ড, ধৰিব পাৰিছা? ঠিক আছে, নেক্সট ইয়াৰ পিছত আমাক লাগিব কি ৰোল নম্বৰটো লাগিব। আমাৰ অলৰেডি কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰখনৰ নাম হৈ গ'ল, কোন ছেমিষ্টাৰ হৈ গ'ল, ইমেইল হৈ গ'ল আৰু ষ্টুডেণ্টৰ নামটো হৈ গ'ল। এতিয়া আমাৰ অলৰেডি থাকি গ'ল ৰোল নম্বৰ। ৰোল নম্বৰটো ভৰাবৰ কাৰণে আৰু এটা আমি এড কৰিব, ইয়াত এড কৰিব লাগিব। এড কৰি দিলোঁ আৰু এটা ঘৰ আহি গ'ল। ইয়াতো আমি ঠিক তেনেকৈ লিখি দিলোঁ যে ইয়াতো আমি লিখি দিলোঁ ৰোল নাম্বাৰ। আৰু সেইটো আমি কি কৰিলোঁ, এইটো শ্বৰ্ট এনচাৰে হৈ গ'ল। আৰু তাৰপিছত আমি ইয়াত কৰি দিলোঁ ৰিকুৱাৰ্ড কৰিলোঁ। আপোনালোকে ধৰিব পাৰিছেনে, এইটো ৰোল নম্বৰ হৈ গ'ল। এতিয়া কি হ'ল যে আমাৰ ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীৰ ডেছক্ৰিপশ্যনটো আমি পাই গ'লোঁ, কোনজন ছাত্ৰই দিব ৰোল নম্বৰ কিমান সেইখিনি আমি পাই গ'লোঁ, ইমেইল পাই গ'লোঁ। ইয়াৰ পিছত আমাৰ মেইন পাৰ্টটো আৰম্ভ হ'ব যে কুৱেশ্যনছবিলাক। সেইটো কাৰণে আপোনালোকে এটা কাম কৰিব লাগিব, এটা ছেকশ্যন কৰি ল'ব লাগিব। ছেকশ্যনটো আপোনালোকে অথনি মই দেখুৱাই গৈছিলোঁ, একেবাৰে তলত ৰাইট ছাইডে মিডল এইট ছেকশ্যন দেখিছেনে, মোৰ কাৰ্চাৰটো দেখিছেনে, উইণ্ড' দেখিছা?
দেখিছোঁ ছাৰ।
ইয়াত ক্লিক কৰাৰ লগে লগে আমাৰ এটা ছেকশ্যন হৈ যাব, অট'মেটিকেলি এটা ছেকশ্যন হৈ যাব। ইয়াৰ সুবিধাটো কি, আমি কণ্টিনিউৱাছ কুৱেশ্যনখিনি দিব পাৰোঁ। তেতিয়া কি হ'ব, ছাত্ৰজনে লগ ইন কৰাৰ লগে লগে গোটেই কুৱেশ্যনখিনি একেবাৰে দেখি যাব। তেতিয়া কি হ'ব যে মই কিছুমান কুৱেশ্যন পৰা নাই বুলি ভাবি আকৌ তাৰপৰা ওলাই গুচি আহিব পাৰিব। আৰু এই প্ৰচেছটোত কি হ'ব, অকল তেখেতৰ নিজৰ ডেছক্ৰিপশ্যনখিনি দিয়াৰ পিছত কুৱেশ্যনখিনি নেদেখে, নেক্সট বা কণ্টিনিউ কৰাৰ পিছতে ছেকেণ্ড ছেকশ্যনটো দেখিব, কুৱেশ্যনখিনি দেখিব। গতিকে আমি এই অপশ্যনটো আমি ল'ব লাগে, আনটাইটেল এইটো ছেকশ্যনটো আমি কৰিব লাগে, আনটাইটেল ছেকশ্যন। গতিকে ইয়াত আমি কি দিম, আনটাইটেল ছেকশ্যন আমি লিখিবলৈ কি কৰোঁ, ইয়াত ক্লাছ ক্লিক কৰক আৰু লিখি দিয়ক যে কুৱেশ্যনছ লিখি দিয়ক, আৰু ডেছক্ৰিপশ্যনত কিবা লিখি দিয়ক যে ইজ এ কুৱেশ্যন কেৰিজ ওৱান মাৰ্ক তেনেকৈ কিবা কিবি লিখি দিব পাৰে, যিখিনি আপোনালোকে ডেছক্ৰিপশ্যন দিম বুলি ভাবিছে ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীৰ। এইখিনি আহি গ'ল আমাৰ। বাকী আমাৰ এতিয়া এই বস্তুখিনি যে আহি গ'ল, আমি যে ইয়াত ছেকশ্যন কৰিলোঁ, সেইকাৰণে ছেকশ্যনটো আমাৰ যিহেতু মাজত গ'ল, এতিয়া কি হ'ল আপোনালোকে দেখিছে যে আমাৰ কাৰ্চাৰটো এই মাজতে হৈ থকাৰ কাৰণে ছেকশ্যনটো ওপৰত গুচি গ'ল কুৱেশ্যনছটো। ইয়াৰ কাৰণে এইটো ধৰি ওপৰলৈ টানি দিয়ক, আহি গ'ল, ওপৰত আহি গ'ল, টেষ্ট আহি গ'ল, ছেকেণ্ড ৰোল নম্বৰ আহি গ'ল, তাৰপিছত কুৱেশ্যন লাষ্টলৈ আহি গ'ল। এতিয়া ফুল নামটো থাকি গ'ল, ফুল নেমটো মাত্ৰ
শুনি আছো, কিন্তু স্ক্ৰীণটো ষ্টেবল হৈ আছে, আপুনি স্ক্ৰীণটো অলপ হেৰি কৰকচোন।
স্ক্ৰীণটো কি লাইভ হোৱা নাই
নেকি? এতিয়া হৈছে, আপুনি কি দেখুৱাইছে কওকচোন। এতিয়া
মই দেখুৱাই আছো এতিয়া তোমাৰ ছেকেণ্ড ছেকশ্যনটো, ছেকেণ্ড ছেকশ্যন 2 অফ 2।
কণ্টিনিউ কৰক।
ঠিক আছে, আমি এটা কুৱেশ্যনখিনিৰ কাৰণে আমি এইটো হেডিং বনাই ললোঁ, হেডিং বনাই ল'লোঁ। আৰু আপোনালোকে যেতিয়া কুৱেশ্যন কেতিয়াবা আগলৈ পিছলে দিব লাগে, মই দিয়াৰ নিচিনাকৈ এনেকৈ এই ওপৰৰ ছিটটো ধৰি লৈ তললৈ লৈ আহিলে এইটো তললৈ গুচি যাব আৰু এইটো ওপৰলৈ গুচি যাব। এইটো হেৰি মই এতিয়াই শিকাই দিছোঁ, বা আকৌ এইটো ওপৰলৈ নিলে এইটো ওপৰলৈ লৈ যাওক, তেতিয়া অট'মেটিক গুচি যাব এইটো চিন্তাৰ কাৰণে। গতিকে আমি কুৱেশ্যনবিলাক কৰিবলৈ এইটো দিলোঁ। এতিয়া নেক্সট আমি কুৱেশ্যন কৰিব লাগে, এইটো হেডিংটো
নিখিল দা, এক ছেকেণ্ড, আপুনি একবাৰ স্ক্ৰীণটো নতুনকৈ শ্বেয়াৰ কৰি লওকচোন। এইটো মানে ষ্টেবল হোৱা নাই স্ক্ৰীণটো, হা, আৰু একবাৰ কৰক শ্বেয়াৰ কৰি স্ক্ৰীণ, হা।
ঠিক আছে
প্লিজ শেয়ার এখন। Nikhilda, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, yes. Now you continue.
গতিকে আপোনালোকে ধৰিব পাৰিছেনে আমি এটা কুৱেশ্যনছ দিবৰ কাৰণে এতিয়া কুৱেশ্যন দিবৰ কাৰণে আপোনালোকে ধৰক বিশটা কুৱেশ্যনৰ এখন প্ৰশ্ন কাকত বনাব এই বিশটা কুৱেশ্যন আপুনি ইয়াত টাইপ কৰি নাথাকিলেও হ'ল আপোনালোকে এটা কাম কৰিব যে আপোনালোকৰ এটা ৱৰ্ড ফাইলত কুৱেশ্যনখিনি টাইপ কৰি ৰাখিব সেইটো মই আপোনালোকক দেখুৱাই দিছোঁ ধৰক মই এইটো টাইপ কৰি ৰাখিছোঁ আমি ফৰ্মখনত গৈ ডাইৰেক্ট টাইপ কৰাৰ প্ৰয়োজন নাই যে আপোনালোকে আগতীয়া ধৰক বিশটা কুৱেশ্যন ছেট কৰি থৈছে বিশটা কুৱেশ্যন ছিৰিয়েলি আপুনি টাইপ কৰি থব উইথ অপশ্যনৰ সৈতে মাল্টিপল চইচ অপশ্যনৰ সৈতে ধৰক মই এইটো কুৱেশ্যন ছেট বুলি বনাই থৈছোঁ এটা গুগল এটা ডকুমেণ্ট ফাইল বনাই থৈছোঁ ইয়াত ফাৰ্ষ্ট কুৱেশ্যনটো হ'ল দ্য টাৰ্ম এনভাইৰনমেণ্ট লিটাৰেচি মিনছ গতিকে আমি এইটো কপি
কৰিলোঁ আপোনাৰ স্ক্ৰীনটো শ্বেয়াৰ হোৱা নাই জাষ্ট দেখুৱাই আছে আপুনি এটা কাম কৰক ছাৰ আপুনি কাইণ্ডলি চাম আপ কৰি দিয়ক মানে স্ক্ৰীনটো শ্বেয়াৰ হোৱা নাই জাষ্ট ষ্টেবল হৈ আছে স্ক্ৰীনটো
যোৱা নাই ন
নাই স্ক্ৰীনটো আহিছে কিন্তু আপোনাৰ ডিছপ্লেখন দেখুওৱা নাই
কি দেখাই আছে এতিয়া
এতিয়া নিখিল হাজৰিকা হেজ ষ্টাৰ্টেড স্ক্ৰীন শ্বেয়াৰিং দেখুৱাইছে কিন্তু আপোনাৰ ডেস্কটপটো নাই দেখুওৱা
এতিয়া
নাই ডেস্কটপটো শ্ব' কৰা নাই গুগল ক্ৰোম তাতে একবাৰ হেৰি কৰি দিয়ক মিনিমাইজ কৰি ফৰ্মখন আপুনি মিনিমাইজ কৰি আকৌ হেৰি কৰি দিয়ক গুগল ক্ৰোমটো
গতিকে আপোনালোকে ইয়াত কুৱেশ্যনখিনি টাইপ কৰিব লাগে টাইপ কৰিবৰ কাৰণে আপোনালোকে ইয়াতে টাইপ কৰিবলৈ কথা নাই আপোনাক এটা ডকুমেণ্ট ফাইলত কুৱেশ্যনখিনি ছেট কৰি থওক সেইটো কাৰণে মই আপোনালোকক দেখুৱাই দিছোঁ সেইটো বৃন্দ গৈছেনে মোৰ এটা ৱৰ্ড ফাইলটো গৈছেনে ৱৰ্ড ফাইলটো গৈছে তাৰপিছত আপুনি ৱৰ্ডৰ পৰা জাষ্ট কুৱেশ্যনটো ফাৰ্ষ্ট কপি কৰক কপি কৰি আনি আপুনি ইয়াত পেষ্ট কৰি দিয়ক তাৰপিছত অপশ্যন ওৱান অপশ্যন টু অপশ্যন থ্ৰী এইখিনি আমি কৰিলে কুৱেশ্যনবিলাক অপশ্যনবিলাক আহিব ইয়াত আপোনালোকে টাইপ কৰিবৰ দৰকাৰ নাই য'ত যিটো আপুনি ৱৰ্ড ফাইলত টাইপ কৰি থৈছে গোটেইকেইটা ছিৰিয়েলি কৰিব চাৰিটাকে এটা এৰি এটা এনেকৈ তাৰপিছত আপুনি জাষ্ট কপি কৰিব আৰু কপি কৰি ইয়াত পেষ্ট কৰি দিব পেষ্ট চাৰিটা অপশ্যনে আমাৰ আহি গ'ল ধৰিব পাৰিছেনে চাৰিটা অপশ্যন আহি যোৱাৰ পিছত আমাৰ কি হৈছে যিটো ব্ৰেণ্ডে কৈছিলোঁ অলৰেডি যে এইটো আমি কুৱেশ্যন এনচাৰ দিব লাগিব কিমান মাৰ্কছ হৈ আছে আমি মাৰ্কছ দিলোঁ ওৱান এইখিনি ব্ৰেণ্ডে অলৰেডি কৈছে তাৰপিছত আমি ডান কৰি দিলোঁ আৰু এইটো ৰিকোৱাৰ্ড কৰি দিলোঁ এতিয়া আপোনালোকে এটা মনত ৰাখিব কুৱেশ্যনখিনি কৰোঁতে সদায় কেতিয়াও ছিৰিয়েল নম্বৰ ওৱান টু থ্ৰী নিদিব ছিৰিয়েল নম্বৰ নিদিব জাষ্ট কুৱেশ্যনটোৱে আৰম্ভ কৰিব ছিৰিয়েল নম্বৰ ওৱান টু থ্ৰী দিলে যিহেতু আমাৰ কুৱেশ্যনখিনি ছেপল হ'ব চেপল হ'ব তেতিয়া আমাৰ যেতিয়া কেতিয়াবা এক নম্বৰ আহিব তাৰপিছত চাৰি নম্বৰ আহিব তাৰপিছত পাঁচ নম্বৰ আহিব তেনেকৈ আহিব গতিকে কুৱেশ্যনবিলাক লিখোঁতে আপোনালোকে কেতিয়াও ছিৰিয়েল নম্বৰ নিদিব তাৰপিছত আপোনালোকে আৰু এটা কাম কৰিব যে কুৱেশ্যনৰ ভিতৰত থকা অপশ্যনখিনিও চেপল কৰিব পাৰি সেইটো কেনেকৈ কৰিব সেইটোৰ কাৰণে আপুনি একেবাৰে ৰাইট ছাইড বটমত আহি যাব বটমত দেখিছেনে ব্ৰেণ্ডৰ চেপল অপশ্যন অৰ্ডাৰ বুলি আছে চেপল অপশ্যন অৰ্ডাৰ ক্লিক কৰি দিব তেতিয়া কি হ'ব আপোনালোকে এই ফাৰ্ষ্ট কুৱেশ্যনটো ওলাওঁতে দ্য টাৰ্ম এনভাইৰনমেণ্টেল লিটাৰেচি মিনছ আপোনাৰ অপশ্যনবিলাক সকলো ষ্টুডেণ্টৰ বেলেগ বেলেগ আহিব কাৰোবাৰ ছাৰাউণ্ডিংটো দুই নম্বৰত আহিব কাৰোবাৰ এয়াৰটো এক নম্বৰত আহিব গতিকে এইটো কাম কৰিব এনেকৈ আপোনালোকে বিশটা কুৱেশ্যন ৰেডি কৰি ল'ব ৰেডি কৰাৰ পিছত এই বস্তুটো আমাৰ গোটেই গুগল ফৰ্মখন হৈ গৈছে অলৰেডি হৈ গৈছে তাৰপিছত আপোনালোকে কি কৰিব কেনেকৈ হোৱাটছএপত আপোনালোকে লিংকটো পঠিয়াব সেইটোৰ কাৰণে আপোনালোকে যাব লাগিব ইয়াত চেণ্ড অপশ্যনত যাব লাগিব চেণ্ড অপশ্যনত গৈ আপোনালোকে ব্ৰেণ্ডত দেখি আছানে হেল্ল' ব্ৰেণ্ডত দেখি আছানে
ইয়েছ 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 কণ্টিনিউ
ইয়েছ সেন্ড অপশনত গৈ আপোনালোকে এই সেন্ড ভায়া এইটো মেইল মেইল কৰি আপুনি দিব পাৰে, প্ৰতিজন ষ্টুডেণ্টে মেইল আছে মেইল কৰি দিব পাৰে, কিন্তু আমাৰ ষ্টুডেণ্টসকলে গম নাপাব মেইলত গ'লে। ঠিক তেনেদৰে আপুনি এই অপশ্যনটোত যাব লিংকটো, ইয়াত আপোনাৰ দুটা লিংক আছে, এটা দীঘল লিংক আছে, এটা চুটি লিংক। যদি চুটি লিংক কৰিব বিচাৰে ইয়াত শ্বৰ্ট টাৰ্ম ইয়াত ক্লিক কৰি দিয়ক আৰু লিংকটো কপি কৰক, আৰু লিংকটো কপি কৰি আপোনালোকে এইটো হোৱাটছএপত পঠিয়াই দিলে আৰু যেতিয়া ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলে সেই লিংকটো মেলিব তেতিয়া দেখিব যে আপোনাৰ এক্সামটো ৰেডি হৈ আছে। এতিয়া কথা হ'ল যে আমি ইয়াত কিছুমান এড অন ফেচিলিটি দিব পাৰোঁ, যিটো প্ৰথম নতুন আপোনালোকৰ কাৰণে অকণমান অসুবিধা হ'ব। সেইটো কাৰণে এটা কাম কৰিব পাৰি, ধৰক আমি যে পৰীক্ষাটো পাতিম আধা ঘণ্টা, মিনিমাম আধা ঘণ্টাৰ কাৰণে পাতিম, সেইটো ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীক আগতীয়াকৈ জনাই দিব লাগিব। ধৰক যে অহা কাইলৈ তোমালোকৰ পৰীক্ষাটো হ'ব 3:30-3:30 ভিতৰত, তেতিয়া আমি এটা কাম কৰিব লাগিব যে গোটেই ফৰ্মখনটো আমি গোটেই দিনটোৰ কাৰণে খুলি ৰাখিব নোৱাৰোঁ। গোটেই দিনটোৰ কাৰণে খুলি ৰাখিবলগীয়া হ'লে ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলে কি কৰিব, পঢ়ি মেলি ধুনীয়াকৈ কিতাপ চাই পৰীক্ষাটো দিব। সেইকাৰণে আমি নিৰ্দিষ্ট এটা আধা ঘণ্টা সময় ল'ব লাগিব, 20 মিনিট সময় ল'ব লাগিব, সেই সময়তে আমি ফৰ্মখন যেন আমি খুলি দিব পাৰোঁ। সেইটো কাৰণে আমি এটা কাম কৰিব লাগিব, আমি এই যে ওপৰত আপোনালোকে দেখিছেনে, ব্ৰেইন দেখিছেনে, কুৱেশ্যনৰ লগত ৰেছপণ্ড বুলি এটা চিম্পল আছে, সেই ৰেছপণ্ডত গৈ আমি এই এচেপ্টিং ৰেছপণ্ডটো আমি আনচেক কৰি ৰাখিব লাগিব। এনেকৈ ন' এচেপ্টিং ৰেছপণ্ড, আমি ফৰ্মখন বনালোঁ, বনাই ইভেন লিংকটো ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীক আমি এদিনৰ আগতো দিলেও দিগদাৰ নাই, দি দিব পাৰোঁ, এদিনৰ আগত দি দিব পাৰোঁ। দি দিয়াৰ পিছত আমি খালি এই এচেপ্টিং ৰেছপণ্ডটো আনচেক কৰি ৰাখিম, আৰু যিহেতু আমি আগতীয়াকৈ এনাউন্স কৰিছোঁ যে 3 বজাৰ পৰা পৰীক্ষাটো হ'ব, গতিকে আমি 3 বজাত এই বস্তুটো খুলি দিম, 3 বজাত এই বস্তুটো খুলি দিম, আৰু ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলে গম পাব যে 3:30 বজাত আমাৰ পৰীক্ষাটো শেষ হ'ব। আৰু ঠিক তেনেকৈ 3:30 বজাৰ লগে লগে আমি, বা তাতকৈ 5 মিনিট এটা সময় আমি বেছিকৈ দি 3:35 আমি এইটো আকৌ নট এক্সেপ্টিং ৰেছপণ্ড কৰি দিম, মানে পৰীক্ষা ক্লোজ। এইটো আমি এনেকৈ নকৰি কিছুমান এড অন লৈ কৰিব পাৰোঁ, যিটো অলপ আপোনালোকে এনেকৈ শিকিবলৈ টান পাব। সেইকাৰণে আপোনালোকে সহজ মেথডটো হ'ল আপুনি ফৰ্মখনৰ ওচৰত যাব আৰু এইটো নট এক্সেপ্টিং ৰেছপণ্ড কৰি ৰাখিব। জাষ্ট পৰীক্ষা আৰম্ভ হোৱাৰ আগে আগে খুলি দিব আৰু পৰীক্ষা শেষ হোৱাৰ লগে লগে এইটো বন্ধ কৰি দিব। আৰু এতিয়া কি হৈছে যে আমি কেনেকৈ যে মাৰ্কছখিনি পাম, সেইটো কাৰণে আপোনালোকে ইয়াত এটা আছে, এইটো গ্ৰীণ এটা প্লাছ চিম্বল আছে, ৰেছপণ্ডখিনি কেনেকৈ ল'ম, ইয়াত ক্লিক কৰি দিলে আপোনালোকে অলৰেডি এখন চিট, নতুন চিট হ'ব, অট'মেটিক নেমটো লৈ ল'ব আৰু ক্ৰিয়েট কৰি দিলেই হ'ল, ক্লিক কৰি দিলেই হ'ল, আপোনালোকৰ গুগল ড্ৰাইভত এইখন ছেভ হৈ থাকিব আৰু তাতে গোটেই ষ্টুডেণ্টৰ নাম এনেকৈ ওলাব, ইমেইল এড্ৰেছ, স্কুল কোনে কিমান পালে, ফুল নেম, ৰোল নাম, এইখন গোটেইখিনি ওলাব আৰু ইয়াৰ পৰা আপুনি কপি কৰি এক্সেল শ্বীটত আনি চৰ্ট কৰি ল'লেই হৈ যাব। ঠিকে আছে নেকি? হৈ গৈছে গোটেই ছেটিংখিনি মই কৈ দিছো, চিম্পল ৱেট কৈ দিছো, গোটেইখিনি কৰি দিছো, খালি জাষ্ট পৰীক্ষাটো আৰম্ভ কৰাৰ আগতে ৰেছপণ্ডটো নট এক্সেপ্টিং ৰেছপণ্ড কৰি ৰাখিব লাগিব আৰু এইটো যেতিয়া ৰেছপণ্ডটো আমি এক্সেপ্টিং এইটো গ্ৰীণ কৰি দিম, এক্সেপ্টিং ৰেছপণ্ড কৰিম, পৰীক্ষাটো খোল খাই যাব আৰু আধা ঘণ্টাৰ পিছত আমি এইটো যিমান সময় দিওঁ আৰু আধা ঘণ্টা, 1 ঘণ্টা 20 মিনিট, তাৰপিছত আকৌ আমি এইটো ক্লিক কৰি দিম পৰীক্ষা আৰু তাৰপিছত বেলেগে দিব নোৱাৰে আৰু। এইটোৱে কথাটো, মেইন কথাটো গুগল ফৰ্মটোত আমি ছেটিংটোৰ কথা, কেনেকৈ আমি ছেটিংটো কুৱেশ্যন পেপাৰৰ কাৰণে কৰি লৈছোঁ আৰু যিটো অলৰেডি মই কৰি গৈছোঁৱেই। ঠিক আছে, থেংক ইউ ডক্টৰ বেন্দ্ৰপাল।
থেংক ইউ ছাৰ, উই হেভ জাষ্ট listen you, it's a very wonderful presentation. Indeed, it will definitely work us, because every day we are working on this all these applications, so definitely it will help our participants to explore more areas, and really it's a great honor that Nikhil Hazarika sir has given this live presentation. It is very difficult to give live presentation, but although he has tried his best sir, thank you very much, and so it's a great honor. Now we will like to move to the next part of this program, that is with us Professor Sanjay Kumar Singh sir is there. Sir, can you hear me?
Yes
sir. Sir, I would like to invite you to give a very short speech as a guest of honor for
you. Thank you Birender for giving the opportunity, and ACLA as well. As all of us know that ACLA is doing a wonderful job in the leadership of Prasanta Kumar Deka and ICT cell coordinator Dr. Bendrapal, and because of that we are here, and other members of ICT cell also, like Nikhil Hazarika is there, Dr. Kojit Das is also there, like that many more will be there. So yes, I am very much delighted here to listen to you. But the thing is that you are just on the web platform for the last more than 2 hours, and what I have seen here that I have been connected, disconnected number of times. So I have opened 2 devices also, sometimes mobile, sometimes laptop, sometimes desktop, but I'm not able to just get connected for continuous, as I have seen that in the beginning, Dr. Kangana Bhushar, she has delivered about the e-resources. There also I could not see the entire activity presented by her. Then again, Birendra Pal has shown you many things related to the web resources, etc. There also sometimes I was coming and going like that. And then at the end, Dr. Nikhil Hajarka has shown you beautiful way how to say take the examination or question paper, question like that type of things. So it is a very good sign for the people of the Assam as well as the teaching fraternity, like students are benefited, the teachers are benefited, even the university teachers as well as the college teachers are benefited from such type of things. Moreover, it is important for the students also in this COVID-19 pandemic time. So we have to keep ourselves busy in our different activities. And this is the only source I can think that through online e-resources, we are updating ourselves. Because you know that because of exposure of literature, number of documents are increasing every minute. It is said that 50 books are added to total number of the documents every minute. And there is no measuring rod in this world that how many documents are being published throughout the country, throughout the world. So whatever it is being published related to your subject, related to area, as you are the teachers of at faculties of the this in law college, so you should be very much familiar with the law subjects. So I am sure that this will be certainly useful for all the teachers, faculties, etc. So I am thankful to the Principal Dr. Gargi Datta Pal, who has taken the initiative for the arranging such type of program. And I would like to thank also to Dr. Kangana Bhushar, Dr. Nikhil Hajarika, Dr. Birendra Pal, Prasanth Deka, and all the participants who are here and really enjoying it. And if my intention to say something here is that even whatever you have seen, 1% if you are adopting it for your day-to-day activities, for your academic activity, you will find that you are successful in your work. And the resource person is also successful. They are also successful in their activities. So with these few words, let me close my speech. So thank you very much, all of you, once again.
Thank you, sir.
Over to Brendan.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. It's a really great honor to hear Professor Sanjay Kumar Singh, sir, head of the Department of Library Information Science, Guwahati University. He's also the librarian in charge of KKND Library of Guwahati University, and also the nodal officer of SOEM of Guwahati University. So really, it's a great honor, sir. Thank you very much to be connected with us. So next, I'd like to invite our General Secretary of Assam College Librarians Association, Dr. P.K. Deka, to give a very short speech. He was disconnected earlier. Sir, Deka, sir, can you hear me?
Okay, yeah.
Please,
sir. That is a common problem, actually, in India. And my internet is slow. I cannot stream video or my phone, my SDB, my tablet not connected. My data, it is a common problem. Actually, if you see in China, that 98% of China already covered by 4G network, and they had completed 75% of classwork during the COVID situation. So that is the problem of India. Anyway, I thank to all our participants there sitting in almost 2 hours, and I want to hear. I would like to inform you that this is our level taking this series of initiatives for capacity building of college library and as well as the academic partners who is online university. Our main motto is for creating more awareness on use of online e-resources directed by MSID, among the library professional teachers, principals, and all academic communities. And we are providing these services voluntary, and it is a modest contribution from us towards the academic community of Assam. And I would like to request all participants to subscribe our SLA YouTube channel also, where we have already posted lots of academic videos that will be benefited for you. And I'm happy to inform you that during this lockdown period, we have successfully completed more than 12 kilometer webinars, this type of awareness camp and different resources in different colleges and institutions of Assam. All the technical needs and handled by the ICT cell, led by our Dr. Birendra Pal. In future, also, we are planning to provide such type of online OGEL for the teachers and students community. And I offer my heartfelt thanks to our resource person, Dr. Konkana Vishwa, National Law University and Judicial Academy, Assam, Dr. Nikhil Hazarika, librarian in charge, God of Death, and member of ICDC and ACLA, and Dr. Birendra Pal. Without him, I cannot think to organize this type of program. And Professor Chandra Singh also, he is very much busy, but he is a stress for our program. Thank you, Dr. Chandra Singh. And I think both all research persons already explained about the careers, which is a platform and recommended by MSRD. And at the end, I would like to offer my special thanks to Principal Madam. We have also felt honored to organize this program in your institution. At the end, once again, I would like to thank our librarian, Pallavi Nair. She is also very active and busy librarian. I know. At the end, I once again welcome all the thanks to all participants for listening us. And I'm eagerly waiting for you feedback form. Definitely, there will be benefited us for our better future. And after that, I thank all of you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Vinod.
Thank you, Deka sir. It's a great honor to hear you. And luckily, you are not disconnected now. Sorry for us. And really, your blessings for the association is really good for us. And we will be working more and more because your motivation, your inspiration is helping us to achieve more things. And this is a voluntary contribution, as already you have said, for the higher education of Assam. So it's a great honor. So next, I would like to move. We cannot take more questions now because we have already crossed more than 2 hours 20 minutes.
Yeah.
And I think this is the highest participants we have got in this program, and this is the program for the highest.
Yes.
Maximum 2 hours we have crossed. We never crossed more than 1 hour 30 minutes. But our content was so deep today, we could not ignore any of these things because of the importance of our participants, because they were sitting with us for the last 2 hours. So we are not ignoring anything. So we are trying our best to give you the best quality presentations from our end with our limitations also. So last, I'd like to invite Gargi Dutta Pol, Madam, Principal of this Law College. Madam, please kindly give one or two suggestions, ignore it may be some views, so that it may help us. Madam, please.
Thank you, Dr. Pal. It was very informative, it met many of the challenges that we have been facing day to day with the start of online classes. So I got the answers for many of the queries I've been struggling with all this. Thank you so much. I should thank the Library Association for giving us this platform, to all the law teachers and beyond, the research scholars, etc., to give us such a platform. Such information will definitely help the legal fraternity in teaching to their students. Thank you so much. Thank you,
madam. Thank you. It's a great honor to hear you, and definitely we'll try our best to make some new kind of academic works in future also, madam. Thank you. And next, going to the last part of this program, that is called vote of thanks. Before going to vote of thanks, that will be given by Miss Pallavi Nayak, madam, the librarian of Dispur Law College. Madam, she is too much active. Every time, from morning to evening, means every time she used to chat and she used to say, how we have to do. The thing I have seen in the Dispur Law College is really lucky that we are in this academic fraternity. And I'm quite sure that she is also giving her best services. And really, madam, it's a great honor because you are trying your best. And because of you and Principal Madam, the entire community of Dispur Law College, we could organize this program. And at least we could have made success this program for everyone. So I'd like to invite Pallavi Nayak, madam, to give her a vote of thanks, please. Unmute yourself, madam, please. Yes.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hello.
Good afternoon.
Am I audible?
Yes.
So finally, we have come to the end of our today's program, and such a beautiful program. And I, Mrs. Pallavi Nayak, librarian of Dispur Law College, would like to take the privilege to propose a vote of thanks on behalf of IQSC, Dispur Law College, and the Assam College Librarians Association. First of all, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to Dr. Prasanta Dekar sir, who has spared his so precious time to deliver such an interesting and informative address, sir. Thank you so much. And I am sure that all the participants have noted your valuable suggestions, sir. I keep in record our indebtedness to Dr. Kangana Bashir ma'am for guiding the participants in exploring the law databases and also making them aware of the deep ocean of e-resources. Thank you, ma'am. Next, please permit me to mention our appreciation for Dr. Nikhil Hajarikar, sir, for his so enlightening presentation on how to conduct the online examinations. Thank you, sir. In this time of crisis, your information will definitely play a big role in the progressing with the present curriculum. I bow my head in gratitude, sir, to Dr. Virendra Pal, who has come to my rescue in the period of crisis during this organization of the program. Thank you, sir. And thank you so much for your very enthusiastic presentation on the different platforms that you have presented on e-resources. Thank you so much, sir. Lastly, my warm thanks goes to Principal Ma'am of the Dispur Law College for her vision, support, and the commitment to the execution of this webinar. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. I'd also like to take a moment to acknowledge the immense contribution of all the participants of the webinar. Thank you. Thank you all. I like to express my sincere gratitude to Dr. Sanjay Kumar Singh, sir, for sparing his so precious time to attend the webinar and encouraging us, sir. Thank you, sir, so much. And your presence is itself like a blessing for us, sir. Thank you so much, sir. And behind this program lay the manifold contribution of faculty members and members of the library of the School Law College. And we will remain obliged for their help. Thank you so much. Thank you all and everyone present in the webinar. And we look forward to meeting you all again and arranging such webinars in the near future. Stay home and stay safe, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Thank you, madam. Thank you. Really, it's a great honor. And
thank you for organizing.
Thank you to the IQC of Dispur Law College. Really, it's a great initiative by them under the leadership of Principal Madam Dr. Gargi Dutta Pol Madam, and coordinated by all the academic fraternity of Dispur Law College. So this is the now end of the program. Just before ending, just I want to share one information that we have shared. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, Professor Sanjay Kumar Singh sir is going to announce something.
I would like to interrupt here just for a few seconds. So thank you for taking the initiative and during my short speech, I have forgotten your name. So it is very good work you are doing.
No problem, sir. Your presence is a boon for us, sir.
Yeah.
No problem, sir. After a long time, to see you, sir.
Just continue such type of activities in future also so that the teachers and the students of your college will be benefited. And there are various e-resources. So Kangana has already shown you the demo and this Nikhil has also shown you. So you just utilize such type of resources. Thank you very much, Brendan. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Just I want to share one important information that on 4th of June 2020 at 2 o'clock, we are going to organize a mega event from Department of Library and Information Science and Assam College Librarians Association. This is a jointly initiative. This is the program on content creation, e-content creation and MOOCs. Basically, those faculty members, it is for college principals, it is for the IQAC coordinators, it is for the SWAYAM nodal officers of the colleges. If you are interested to develop your own MOOC courses in SWAYAM, আপোনালোকে যদি নিজৰ স্বয়ংত কোর্স নিজে বনাব খুজিছে বা এনেকা আইডিয়া কিবা লাগিলে উই আর গোইং টু কন্ডাক্ট এ প্রোগ্রাম ফর ইউ অন 4th জুন 2020 এট 2 o'clock and the registration will be started from today evening in our website of Assam College Librarians Association. We will also share the link in the different WhatsApp groups. So I request everyone to participate in this program because Abhishek Kumar, the scientist deep from Infibnet Center, he is the President of India Award, and he is working with lots of MHRD projects like SWAYAM, NIRF, IRMIS, and different research and R&D databases. So he's the person who's going to connect with us. It is very difficult to connect with Abhishek Kumar sir. So he will be with us. So I request everyone to be connected with us in this platform of June 4. It is very important. And also next, we have shared the feedback form in the group. So kindly give your feedback form. It is also related with our certificates. So please kindly say, please fill up the feedback form. It will be available till 2 hours. After 2 hours, we'll stop this feedback form. So before 2 hours, that means it is already 1:30. So after 3:30, we will stop this feedback form. So kindly share your feedback. And at the last, I would like to end this meeting. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you, everybody.